here. One of the great Milwaukee summer festivals. And we'd like to send you there. Compliments of Discount Liquor. Hi, this is Marie from Discount Liquor. Purchase any one 18-pack of Miller Lite, Draft, or 64, or Coors Light, and receive one free ticket to Irish Fest. But don't delay. Tickets go quickly, and I know you don't want to miss all the great Irish food and beverages. Visit us today at 51st in Oklahoma and Milwaukee, and on Barstow and Main in downtown Waukesha. Discount Liquor, voted best liquor store in Milwaukee again. See us this week for your free Irish Fest ticket.
The only thing that tops our selection is your savings. Discount Liquor.
Check out all of our weekly specials at discountliquorinc.com.
I'm Tony Burrell, Superintendent of the Wisconsin State Patrol. Public safety is our primary mission. Every day, our troopers and inspectors work hard to keep people and commerce moving safely. But drivers need to do their part. That means following these simple rules. Buckle up, phones down, slow down. Thanks for helping us move towards zero deaths on Wisconsin roads.
A life-saving message, sponsored by the U.S. and Wisconsin DOTs.
Kevin Moret here from Mentality Men's Health. Guys, did you know that the stored belly fat reduces your free testosterone? The more the belly grows, the harder it is to drop, mostly because of the decrease in free T. It's a vicious cycle that men are losing, and unfortunately, everyone can see it. Mentality breaks that cycle with semaglutide, an industry-changing weight loss medication that can help you lose up to 15% of your body weight while preserving your testosterone. Join our over 20,000 clients to look and feel the way you deserve. In Milwaukee, go to lowtusa.com. That's lowtusa.com.
You're listening to 94.5 ESPN, WKTI and WKTI HD Milwaukee, a Good Karma Brands radio station.
Showtime.
The right way to start your day. This is Jen, Gabe, and Chewy.
I'm no alpha.
Well, then you can't hang with us. I'm sorry.
You never invite us anyway.
If sloppiness is the reason why you don't want to eat wings on the bone,
it's not just
you're not hanging out with me in the blammer ever.
I don't think it's the kind of thing you want to hear about your father. But I'll tell you, when he came out of that bathroom and he was kneading that dough, it was a wild scene.
How could he not have washed?
Even if you're not going to soap up, at least pretend for my benefit. Turn the water on. Do something.
This is Jen, Gabe, and Chewy.
If you invite us, I will be as sloppy as I need to be to hang out. I immediately regretted saying that. But I can't just... I
think you just got uninvited.
You puppy? I'm a puppy. I think you better come with me. What's the problem?
What do they want from Poppy?
Well, Poppy's a little sloppy.
This is Jen, Gabe, and Chewy, broadcasting live from the Gruber Law Office's One Call That's All Studios at The Avenue with Gabe Neitzel and Mark Chamora. Here's Jen Latta.
Running her mouth, she wants to ride it. She's trying to hide it. I'm cool as ever, she's too excited. Her man look like he wanna fight. He ain't doing nothing but running his mouth. Talk about it, we all about it. They making plans, we sitting down. Our chairs stacked just like a mountain. You heard about it, she running.
A lot of energy here in the Gruber Law Office's One Call That's All Studios, especially for a Monday. Now, is that simply because Chewy's not here and he brings us down on Mondays?
100%.
That's what I thought.
We can say that because he's not listening.
I'm glad that we got that established right away.
I would say that to his face, and he would probably agree. He hates being here on Mondays.
Yes, and then he infects the rest of us. We have to fight it. We're like actively fighting the infection. Like red blood cells. We're the red blood cells.
All right, thank you, Miss Frizzle, for today's science lesson.
And the magic school bus. It's amazing. Big weekend around these parts, man. There was a lot to do. I felt like somebody was asking me to do something everywhere, every day. That includes God, because on Sunday we baptized our youngest.
The Lord asked you to bring the child into the family.
And we obliged. Let us pray. So we did that on Sunday. Went to the state fair earlier this week. Ashley, I heard you also went to the state fair.
Whatever.
Have you been before?
I went once before, a couple of summers ago.
Okay, because I still have not been.
And I enjoyed it last time. We were there for far too long last time, probably 5 hours, which is 4 hours more than you need to be.
Ooh, I don't think that people would think that 5 hours at the state fair is too long.
So here's what I figured. I didn't hate my time. We went on Friday night. It was just, it was fine. It wasn't that enjoyable. Maybe we didn't walk around as much. I met up with people who had been there since like 2 in the afternoon.
Oof. So they were at 2 and you got there at what time?
About 6:15, 6:30. Right,
I'm working through the logistics.
Yeah, so they were there for a while. And then, so, you know, you go there, we get a couple things that you want to do. One of my friends went with, just had to get a corn dog. That was the reason. She's like, I got to get a corn dog. Great. We can get those at, you know, Sam's Club, but that's fine too.
So no. Was your friend named Jen Latta? Because that's like literally my thing. The first thing I do when I get to the state fair is get a foot-long corn dog.
If wow. you can get a fresh corn dog at some sort of fair or festival, yeah, it's literally 1,000 times better than the frozen one. Because then, you throw it in the microwave, it gets soggy. It's no, you get a good, crisp.
Yes, absolutely.
Yes.
I don't know. About
I stand
a
by that.
It's a little bit better.
I stand by that.
Okay, I'm putting that in the poll.
The hot dog was fantastic.
Oh, then you get like a really good mustard or something.
Yeah,
and
I'm sure it's great.
Absolutely. And you're at the fair, so you can walk around, and if that mustard drips off a little bit, it's just landing on the fair ground.
Still, then you're just trying to fit in with people who are already at the fair. It's fine.
Yeah, get them mustard on the shirt.
I have a firm belief about the fair, and it's two types of people go to the fair: people who belong at the fair, and then people who go to see the people who belong at the fair. That's my personal thing about the fair. Shout out.
Why are you insulting?
Trying to figure. Out which one of those I belong to, actually.
Well, I know of the state of Wisconsin.
Can I be honest about that, you guys? I get super emotional. I get super emotional every year walking through the where they keep the cows and where they keep the sheep and where they keep the, because I love that these kids, and so many of them, as you mentioned, 4-H kids, mm-hmm. that this is their livelihood. Like, they start at a young age, they got pictures and posters. Remember those 3-sided boards we used to make projects on back in middle school? Okay. They've got those throughout the, and I can't think of what they're called, but where they keep the cows and where they keep the sheep and where they keep the all the things at the fair. And they've got these boards and it has their name on them. It's not a barn though, right? It's like a pavilion. It's like a, anyway, and they've got all of their information, how long they've been raising these animals and all that stuff. And like, to me, there's just like, I don't know, maybe it's a throwback type of thing to like a simpler time or whatever it is, but it feels to me like a very like Americana. And I don't know why it affects me emotionally every time I go in there. I don't know. It's a pride thing. I can't nail it down. I just know that I have feelings. I catch feelings every time I walk through there.
I thought you were catching feelings because of what happened to the animals after the fair.
No.
Okay.
I felt appropriate. I didn't want to play the buzzer sound.
In fact, you should try the sliders that they have over at the camp bar because those were delicious.
I did, however, try one of the sports. My other issue is that there needs to be more signs. Apparently, there's a ton of signs. I'm sure there are a ton of signs about the weird food because I want to go to the state fair to eat weird food. That's my one goal. I want to eat
weird
food.
That would make sense for you.
I want to eat weird food. I'm not eating bug chow mein. I'm sorry. That's where I draw the line. Is it bugs? Jen already forced me to do that once, and that's good enough in my life. I just wanted to eat some weird food. There's not enough signs to me about where to walk to get the weird food, or I'm just oblivious. Probably the second one, but I don't want to do that.
I think they even have tiny pamphlets.
You walk in, they've just got here. Here's the map. Like
of
when
the
you walk,
Sporkies.
Yeah, when
and
you
the drinkies.
Into the amusement park.
I think.
Probably
yeah. And maybe it's because you're so tall, and so you just walk right past the things
that's
that are right. down
I,
at
I
my level.
I had my high life. That was fine. I was in great
shape.
But
you said you didn't have a good time, and that surprises me because I always have a good time at the Wisconsin State Fair.
How expensive is
maybe I'm doing it wrong. I don't know. We got free tickets, so it was $0 for me.
Well, yeah, but like, is the food like priced appropriately?
I think for a fair it is.
If you go to Summerfest, because that's the one thing Chewy always wants to compare it to. Like, I don't complain when I go to Summerfest because I know I don't complain when I go to the ballpark. I know the beer is going to be a little extra. Like, it's going to be a little priced. You understand that going in. But with all the different food items that they have, like are the prices jacked up a little bit?
Say if you spend $50, that's probably a drink or two and a food. I mean, like, what are you spending more than $50 at the fair for?
Well, so I'm going to soften the blow here and say that we got...
So, Jen's face is turning red. Well, actually...
50 times what?
We got the tickets for free.
Yeah,
okay,
of course.
All right.
Dario Judge the Sporkies.
If I was about to say, if you work in media and
you
don't
should,
get
yes,
free
tickets. Exactly. So we did not have to pay for tickets. We had a parking pass to one of the premier lots, so that
beautiful.
Helps cut down on the cost.
Same is great.
But I think, you know... Rounding up. Nah, let's round down. Rounding down sounds better. We'll round down.
Okay.
Carry the one. I think I spent $9,000 at the fair.
Excuse me?
American?
In this economy?
In any economy. Is American
that,
dollars?
Is that a lot? Does that seem unreasonable?
$9,000 seem, unless you're going to Ewald Automotive.
Coming home with a vehicle?
Coming, you know, spending $9,000 at one place seems, I don't know, a little excessive.
What could you buy there for? How many things?
So what? Here's what I would recommend. If you're not in the market for spending $9,000 at the Wisconsin State Fair, might I suggest you don't walk through the old Expo Center, okay?
You were preaching the virtues and values of the Expo Center just a couple of weeks ago on this very fine program.
Yes, well, there's a sucker born every minute, and apparently I'm the first one.
I didn't realize your gambling had turned around to the point where you could spend $9,000.
Let's just talk for a minute. You walk into the Expo Center, and they've got the pull tabs right there. So I did spend $60 on pull tabs. I gave my husband a 20. I gave Chaser a 20. I took a 20, and we won $21. Spent $60, won $21. All right, so it is.
So you're down $39 already.
Made that donation to the Wisconsin State Fair or the Wisconsin Lottery, whoever collects that. And then we were looking for pans. Because our pans, our kitchen pans, are a disaster.
Yeah,
everything sticks to the
I don't know. The minute that I'm just thinking, like, there's something here with 9,000. Continue, I'm sorry.
So, pans, we were looking for pans.
You can't spend $9,000 on pans.
No, I could, for being honest. But.
And they have the demonstrations, right? They got the guys with the tiny Britney Spears mics, right? And they're telling stories. And they've got,
just so you know,
full audience for those people, by the way. All of the seats in front of the pan demonstrations are always full, right? It's standing room only. Those guys are artists, okay? We need to give them their due. Because somehow they're selling pans.
So you like flipping an egg there?
With no Pam. No Pam. But we did not purchase pans at the Wisconsin State Fair.
Okay, so you go in thinking, all right, we know the Expo Center could probably get a good deal on pans. You come back panless.
Correct. The next thing we were looking for at the Expo Center was a wagon, because we have tiny children, and we have had luck before at some of these fairs at the Big E when we lived in Connecticut.
You might be able to get a Wagoneer for around $9,000.
Exactly. Used, but pre-owned. It'd be nice. It'd still be nice. And so we thought we'd buy a wagon for the kids. And we looked and we looked and we looked and we couldn't find the wagons. However, we did stumble upon a sauna.
A sauna?
Did I stutter? Yes, a sauna.
But how do you stumble?
Well, they got a big
display. Okay, I don't have much experiences in saunas. They just have saunas for sale.
Yes,
at the Expo Center?
Have you ever been to a place where they have hot tubs for sale or boats for sale?
Also found at
State
Fair.
All of these things.
But a sauna is an actual room.
It is a room, yes, and it's a portable room. It's the kind that you build. It's a buildable room, and so I've been looking for a red light therapy, cryo, and it's not called cryo, it's another term that I can't remember at this point.
Cryo is usually the opposite of the heat.
Slightly embarrassed. And I ended up purchasing a sauna at the state fair. Whomst among us has not purchased a sauna at the state fair?
Wait, so you are now going to have a sauna in your house?
Yes, in the basement, yes.
All right, I don't want to hear you ever. No, you and Chewy are now on a team. Like, when we start talking about things in homes, and you're like, oh, Chewy the rich guy, you are going to have a sauna in your basement.
Yeah, it's...
by the way, good for you.
Wait,
more power to you, but, you're now in that tax bracket.
I want to be very clear. We did not spend all $9,000 on the sauna. That would
percentage?
Be ridiculous.
Now, you've already told us you spent $9,000, so let's break it down. What percentage?
Did we spend on the sauna?
Just out of curiosity.
50% on the sauna.
That means you spent... Oh, my God.
So then...
What did you spend? $4,500? That's a lot
That's
of corn dogs. That's
450 corn dogs.
Corn dogs, Jackie. Corn dogs.
No. So then the boys were walking through the Expo Center, and they saw one of those, video game arcade places where you can buy a video game arcade like they used to have in the old arcades. And they got real excited.
One of the big standing ones?
Standing ones, yes. They got real excited for one that had 5,000 games, including all the old school ones like Tetris.
$1 per game available.
And Tetris and Pac-Man and Galactica or something like that. I don't know that one.
Galactica. Just thinking about relaxing in your sauna, so you just decided to throw relax in the middle of a video
Galaga?
Game?
Galaga, that's what it was called. Yep, Galaga. And Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles and Mortal Kombat and all of the Marios. Every single Mario was in there. And so we pulled the trigger on that, too.
So that was $4,500 as well?
It was $3,000.
You still spent $1,500 elsewhere?
Well, taxes and whatnot. So I guess I sort of...
$9,000?
I broke the curve, huh?
Yes, 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 you did. Like, if they're... when the state fair folks, you know, at the end of the state fair are tallying up and figuring out how much the average person spent at the state fair, yes, you are dragging down everybody else.
800-990-3776. Shockingly, we have a lot of reaction to this revelation. Dave from Aaron, however, saying, we once spent $9,000 in one shot at the state fair. The hot tub will get you every time. Dumpy in West Bend saying, speaking of Chewy, Jen got a hot tub. Jake from State Farm saying...
You don't have to read every text. Why do we have to keep going over this?
Jake from State Farm weighing in saying, I walked through the Expo Center once. I had some fun. I wondered what kind of special, stupid person buys something on a whim at this thing. I guess you've answered my question. Unnamed in the 414 saying, Jen, you will love the infrared sauna. We bought one at the State Fair several years ago. It is amazing. I appreciate the endorsement. Unnamed in the 414 also saying, wait a second. The $9,000 wasn't just a Jen exaggeration. Well, to be fair, I only had to put a portion of each of those down, but eventually I will spend $9,000.
Were you feeling a little bit guilty that you had decided to buy the sauna, and that's why you gave the okay? Did Dario and your son sense an opportunity to pounce? Because I feel if you were just walking through the Expo Center and they found that, you would say, no, you're dumb, we're not spending that on a video game machine.
Gabe, how dare you? That is exactly what happened. That is exactly
like
what happened.
Like, they just sensed it. Like,
they did. Yeah. They were like, Mom's going to buy this sauna, yes. And here's the thing.
We got to level the playing field.
Exactly. We see a window. We got to take advantage of it. And that's what they said. So we are beginning our basement remodel with our friends over at PCI today. So I think that video game console has a nice home right underneath the stairs. And so hopefully it continues to add to our rec area that we are adding there. But yes, 800-990-3776. Have you ever gotten suckered into a big purchase? Have you accidentally wandered through the Expo Center at the Wisconsin State Fair and left $9,000 poorer? 800-990-3776.
I think if I were to add up every sucker purchase I've ever made, I don't think it's even going to equal $9,000.
You mean at the state fair?
I've never been to the state fair.
See, that's more egregious to me that you have lived in Wisconsin your entire life, that he's lived in this state all 40-ish, not yet, but 40-ish years. Wow.
She rounds down for her money and then rounds up for my age.
3 whole years you rounded up. Jeez.
Unbelievable.
Well, once you pass the 5.
You've never down to 35.
Been to the state fair.
Never been to the state
fair. That's insane to me. Is that more egregious than me spending $9,000 at the fair? I think it is. Jerry and Kewoskum.
Whatever you got to tell yourself.
Weighing in saying, we also got suckered into a $9,000 hot tub a few years ago. Right there with you, Jen. Seems like maybe there are some people out there who are in the same situation.
Okay, but... I'm trying to debate how much these people actually got suckered, because if you're buying a hot tub, you're probably already thinking about that purchase, because the hot tub is not small. Like, you've already planned out where in the house or where outside of the house you're going to be putting said hot tub. So I don't know if you got suckered into it as much as you saw an opportunity because you had already been thinking about it.
Well, and to be fair, I had been looking at these saunas since February. And I have the text chain in my phone still that I was able to show the gentleman. It happened to be the same company that we had been speaking to then. Happened to have the same exact text conversation in my phone. And I was like, look, this is not me just like joking around. I've been looking for a sauna for... you know, almost a year. Good Health Saunas is the name of the company. Good Health Saunas is the name of the company that we are getting our sauna from and that I have been talking to since February. So it feels a little less like a sucker job, you know, and like I got $9,000 burning a hole in my pocket. I just want to spend it on something than a little pre-planned.
How much are you going to use the sauna?
Hopefully every day. Hopefully every day. So the guy was telling me one of the great things about it is you can set it like your coffee machine, essentially. You set it for a certain time, takes 20 minutes to warm up, and then you go down and hopefully, you know, depending on what time of day I decide to do it, it's already ready for you to go. You go down there, you sit in the sauna for 20 to 30 minutes, you get all those toxins out of your body. And what I said to him, you know, because he was selling me, but I was selling him, I'm a 42-year-old woman on television, Gabe. I need all the help I can get at this point.
Well, I've got nothing to add.
Gabe, I look forward. I look forward to this being a reason why you're late for the number of different places that you show up tardy to.
The Fountain of Youth. That's what I did, Gabe. I bought the Fountain of Youth at the Wisconsin State Fair. We got to take a break. We roll on right after this.
Jen, Gabe, and Chewy continues next on 94.5 ESPN.
No delays to report, but we do have some debris in the road if you're traveling eastbound in Waukesha County, 94 East at Wisconsin 83. You could expect some lane closures due to debris in the middle of the road, but otherwise looking pretty good across the system. Traffic is brought to you by the Lake Country Dockhounds in Oconomowoc. Enjoy a family-friendly baseball experience in Lake Country, where summer nights last longer. Go to dockhounds.com to get your tickets. And your weather for today, partly sunny, spotty shower possible with a high of 79. Tonight, partly cloudy, a low of 65. On Tuesday, mostly sunny, pop-up storms possible, a high of 84. Wednesday, mostly sunny, a slight chance of a shower or storm and high of 86. And on Thursday, mostly sunny and a high of 83 degrees. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Steph Graham on 94.5 ESPN.
The time has come for another Delzer ESPN Milwaukee Open at the Bog in Saukville. We're excited to be out there all day long on August 8th. The 2023 Delzer ESPN Milwaukee Open at the Bog is sponsored by Welke's Milwaukee Florist, Discount Liquor, The Jewelry Center, Von Breezen, Fifth Third Bank, Cider Heating, Gruber Law Offices, Perky's Old Fashioned, Fast Signs, Three Tree Marketing, and Wisconsin Golf Trips.
Does that knee pain keep getting worse? How about that pain in your shoulder or your hip or your back? Don't let them tell you steroids and surgery are your only option. Take my advice now and call QC Kinetics. Hey, it's Tony Smith. QC Kinetics can make that pain go away with all-natural, advanced regenerative medicine. They're helping people here in Milwaukee every day with these amazing natural treatments that restore and repair damaged joint tissue. Regenerative medicine uses concentrated healing agents from your own body to stimulate that damaged tissue in your joints so they can work like they're supposed to. And there's zero downtime. QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in this exciting medical breakthrough. Patients here are getting real, lasting relief. And they're saying no to surgery and drugs. If you have pain due to an injury or arthritis, this is a remarkable option that you need to check out. And the consultation is free. Call QC Kinetics now. 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. QC Kinetics. 414-285-3474.
Buckle up. It's all systems go at Pottawatomie. Plug in to High Wattage Play and you could win an all-electric BMW i7. Play now through September with your club card. Prize drawings on Thursdays. There's a shocking $800,000 in total prizes on the line, including the luxury BMW i7. It's time to electrify your drive. Only at Pottawatomie Casino Hotel. More info at paysbig.com/BMW. Must be 21 years old and a club member to play.
Here in Wisconsin, one name is synonymous with fantastic frozen pizza, Palermo's. For almost 60 years, Palermo's has focused on feeding Wisconsin families. And though Palermo's has grown a lot since 1964, they're still family-owned. They're still proud to call Milwaukee home. And they're still committed to making the best frozen pizza possible. From their new and improved rising crust pizzas to their guilt-free Primo Thin Pies, Palermo's has a delicious slice for every appetite. Find Palermo's in your local grocer's freezer food aisle. Palermo's. Flavor is our family's business.
Look at all this space I have on my desk. Finally, no more clutter.
I know, right? Plus, now I can actually see everyone and talk to them whenever I want.
Would you stop trying to ask people if there are more doors or wheels in the world?
Speaking of wheels, these chairs, woo!
I've never been more comfortable at work.
Coakley Brothers and Brothers Interiors, the official moving and furniture provider of GKB Milwaukee. This is Jen, Gabe, and Chewy.
Probably are forums, groups, areas where you can find someone in that space.
Yeah, but here's the thing. I'm just a normal person, so that doesn't really apply to me. That hurts. Not gonna lie.
You're not normal.
On 94.5 ESPN.
Been suckered into a big purchase. Dropped a small fortune at the Wisconsin State Fair over the weekend. And I don't really feel bad about it, if I'm being honest.
I mean, no, you got some cool things for your $9,000. That's undeniable. Wait, you don't think those things are cool?
An infrared sauna? Nah.
Whatever it is, it's a...
The video game thing's cool, though. I'm into that.
Yeah, and I have a 14-year-old, so he'll be super into that. But Dave from Aaron weighing in saying, in your defense, anything you buy at State Fair is about $2,000 less than buying from the business. That's how they get you, right?
So they've got the discount.
They give you a deal because you're at the State Fair. Dave from Aaron, my new favorite person here, because he's continuing
he's
to justify.
Really stepping up for
continuing
you.
To justify the, well, he said he bought the hot tub as well. So he's like
Dave,
but
also
I was like,
got
a hell of a deal. I got a hell of a deal. Speaking of a hell of a deal, family night up at Lambeau Field is always a hell of a deal for people who might not be able to make it to a game during the season. 65,000 plus filled Lambeau on Saturday night for the family night. Now, it's not called a scrimmage anymore. Am I reading that correctly?
Yeah, because it's just a practice.
Used to be a family night scrimmage. Mm-hmm. It looked to me at times like it was more of a skills competition than anything else, because I was not at Lambeau Field. I was watching on television. And that was, woof, that was rough.
It's bad. It's a bad TV product.
It was tough to figure out what was going on. They've got these tight camera shots. At one point, I'm watching Sean Clifford try to put the ball in a basket at the back of the end zone, going, what are we doing here? By the way, Sean Clifford apparently is really impressing people to the point where they cut Danny Etling this weekend. So apparently they really like what they've got in the backup quarterback, Sean Clifford. But I digress. Do we still need to be doing this?
Doing what? Tight shots so you're not showing anything at practice?
Well, that, yes, and I would love to discuss that, but I just mean, in general, this idea of family night being a practice. Because it doesn't, and maybe it is a practice, maybe that's how the team justifies still doing it. To me, you should just flip it over to a skills comp. You should just flip it over to a skills comp, go the way that the NFL, the Pro Bowl has gone, and set up a bunch of stations and have the guys run through that and entertain the fans, if that's what it's for, if it's for the 65,000 people who are in there. Because I'll tell you what, for me at home watching, hoping to get another glimpse with my own eyeballs of this team and what they can do and the progress they've made, I got none of it. I got none.
So
zero.
The problem is, with how limited practices are now, even if you do a skills competition, that's probably counting as one of the practices that you can have. So they want to have some value to it. That's why they still have, you know, their competition periods and their one-on-ones. And it's basically another practice, just like the one you went up to a couple of weeks ago at Rainichke Field. They just go across the street and do it in front of 65,000 people instead of the 5,000 they can put in the stands around Rainichke Field.
So why don't they offer the people who are watching on television the same experience, or at least a comparable experience, right? That's always been the big argument, is how do you make the in-arena experience similar to the at-home experience? And I would say that this failed miserably, because the people in the arena were able to watch at least some actual practice, actual scrimmage, right? Even though they're not calling it a scrimmage, there was some actual scrimmaging that went on. But if you were watching on the television at home, you didn't get to see, you certainly didn't get to see complete drives. Maybe you saw one play that either was successful for the offense or the defense that they rolled back after a break in maybe slow motion, right? Like, that's not what I think people at home are tuning in for.
No, and based on the reaction on Twitter, that's definitely not what people were tuning in for. They're hoping to see practice much like you. But I think that goes to Murphy Takes Five. Mark Murphy strikes again. Somebody had asked him why they weren't streaming Family Night this year as they had in years past, and he leaned on the old competitive advantage. We don't want, you know, we've got a new quarterback and the scheme's going to be a little bit different. We don't want our competitors to gain an advantage over us, so we're going to limit everything we put out there.
That doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, I understand, because scouts are allowed at Lambeau Field.
Because scouts are allowed at Lambeau Field. So this is for whatever percentage of scouts might have decided not to hop a plane to Austin Straubel and take in Family Night live? Because then so if you did happen to go to Lambeau Field on Saturday night as a scout, then you saw all of the things that Mark Murphy says they're trying to keep people from seeing.
Yeah, I guess he wants them to spend that money on the flights.
Get it out of their budget.
Yeah, I don't.
One penny at a time, we're going to get those guys.
These billionaires that are just making hand over fist every Sunday. It doesn't make any sense to me. And I will always fight for Family Night to exist for the reason that you stated earlier, in that I was a kid that always wanted to go to Packer games, always, but it's expensive. Like when you're talking for a family of four at two, you know, around 150, 200 tickets, you know, $200 a pop. Yeah, that gets expensive. That gets pricey for a lot of families. But family night, like we went to family night a couple of times when I was a kid. I absolutely loved it. It was fantastic. It was an actual scrimmage back then, but that's not the things were better back in our day type thing that I want to point I want to make. It's for people who want to get to Lambeau Field because it is a special place. But I don't understand the competitive advantage thing. I think coaches and teams go way too far with this. Like, you're telling me that teams can't look back and see what you've run with Jordan Love? Like, it's going to be that drastically different? You hear Chew talk about it all the time, about how plays and concepts aren't really all that different from when he played. Yeah, maybe how you get to them or the formation might be a little bit different, but all the concepts are basically the same. Like, these are people who literally breathe, eat, sleep football because that's their job. They paid millions of dollars for it. You're telling me your competitors don't have an inkling of what you're going to do, that they're going to come in. The Bears are coming in completely clueless as to what Jordan Love and this Packers offense is going to be week one of the regular season?
No.
And really, that's all you're doing it for, right? Is week one of the regular season, because after week one of the regular season, then a bunch of stuff is out there. The other 16 teams on your schedule. Enough. So I just
and obviously
don't...
that incrementally goes up week by week. Shout out to Twitter, however, Twitter or X, whatever it is, because I was able to watch plays. All of the plays that Mark Murphy and company were supposedly trying to keep out of the hands of the enemy were all on Twitter anyway, because people in the stands were taking video and people in the stands were posting video. And this is the same juxtaposition or paradox, if you will, that exists at practice. The media watches, the media takes notes, the media is able to tweet out what happened. But the people on the other side of the field are able to shoot and video what is happening, and then they push it out. And actually, it's become pretty brilliant, guys. Now, if you are a fan in the stands at Ray Nischke Field, you just wait for a reporter who has a lot of clout, a lot of followers, you know, will certainly get attention on their tweet, to tweet the play that just occurred, and you respond to that tweet with your video. And guys are making jokes now, like, just wait a few minutes, somebody will post a video of said play, and you'll be able to watch it. It does scream paranoia to me. It does. And look, we have talked about the difference, right? And it being razor thin between wins and losses and success and failure in the NFL. But I'm with you, Gabe. This takes it way too far. To me, it doesn't, you're not gaining enough of a competitive advantage by seeing it. And that takes away from the fans who, again, were watching at home, who were unable to get up to Lambeau because, again, they were sold out. It's not like even if you wanted to go, you could go because tickets were gone. So if you're trying to watch to get a little bit of insight into the offense and see how your team is going and kind of further your excitement, I think they missed the boat. And I don't think that for the reason they stated, it was enough of a good reason to do that.
Well, especially because this is the team, and I know Jason has made this point, he made it on Twitter again, leading into this game. Not even game, practice, whatever Saturday night was. For a team that loves to lean into, we're owned by the fans. Okay, then do something for your fans. Make it easy to consume the family night scrimmage for those who can't get there. Because you got fans across the country. You're excited about that. You're excited to take their money across the country internationally when you do these stock sales. So, like, I understand you're probably limited with the number of things that you can do for your fan base. But if you're going to lean into, oh, we're community owned, we're owned by our fans, then do something for your fans. And making family night scrimmage an easy thing to consume doesn't seem like a big ask.
We will get into some of the details from Family Night, which, of course, we were able to glean from articles written by journalists and social media posts that people put on there. Not so much from the television broadcast. And then I was like, come on, Jordan, you got to put one in there. You got to put one in there. And he was like, yes! I was in my living room, and I was like, yes! So funny how invested I am in this kid's success. Your reaction to Family Night on television, if you watched. And again, I want to be very clear. I spoke to a number of people who were actually at Family Night on Saturday. Loved it. Love the environment. There's that magic. There's that mystique that Lambeau always offers. Of course, if you've got young kids, you know, nothing beats the fireworks over Lambeau Field. But you're not tuning into the television broadcast to see the fireworks. So did you get anything out of watching it on television? 800-990-3776. We roll on right after this.
More Jen, Gabe, and Chewy coming up on 94.5 ESPN.
Still dealing with some debris in the road if you are traveling in Waukesha County on 94 eastbound at Wisconsin 83. We have cars avoiding that in the center of the road. But otherwise, things are looking good across the system. No real delays or issues to report at this time. Traffic is brought to you by Fisco Auto Body. Call Fisco Auto Body to help with all body repair needs. Fisco, Fisco, Fisco. Taking a look at your weather for today, partly sunny, spotty shower possible, a high of 79. Tonight, partly cloudy and a low of 65. On Tuesday, mostly sunny, a pop-up storm is possible, a high of 84. On Wednesday, mostly sunny, slight chance of a shower or storm and a high of 86 degrees. Thursday, mostly sunny, high 83. And on Friday, a chance of rain or storms and partly cloudy and a high of 85 degrees. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Steph Graham on 94.5 ESPN.
Kevin Redd here from Mentality Men's Health. We hear stories every day in our clinics that what used to work for guys doesn't anymore. Increased cardio, cut out certain food, nothing stops the changes in their bodies, especially the weight. The fact is, years of decreasing testosterone has packed on the belly fat that won't go away. We've introduced a medication, semaglutide, that helps drop 15% of the body weight on average while preserving testosterone. Join the over 20,000 Mentality clients and jumpstart your results. In Milwaukee, go to lowtusa.com. That's lowtusa.com.
The James Imaging Systems people, they're one reason why so many businesses choose to do business with James, like Brookfield GMC, controller Jay Doyle.
They're compatriots to the point where when I call, they act like they're your best friend.
Document imaging technology, managed print services, content management solutions, all supported by the James Imaging Systems people. People who are dedicated to helping your business do business better.
They do a great job. They're like it's one of your workers. They want to help.
Not tomorrow, not next week. Help when you need it. That's James Imaging Systems.
Yeah, they do a great job. They're there immediately, and it's a great feeling because I know they care.
James Imaging Systems.
I do love working with James Imaging. It's perfect.
Put the good people at James Imaging Systems to work for your business. Call 262-781-7700 or visit jamesimaging.com. James Imaging Systems, your local office technology partner.
Bundling and saving with GEICO is an easy choice, so you're free to ponder life's big questions, like, what's the best animal in the world if not humans? I'd strongly consider ducks to be somewhere up there on the list. Think about it. Ducks can swim, ducks can fly, and ducks can walk on land. They have access to all terrains. They are the ultimate animal. And they wiggle their butts when they walk, which is funny. Yeah, ducks are awesome. End of story. Bundling and saving with GEICO. It's an easy choice.
For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile, and the ones who get in early so everyone can go home on time, there's Grainger, offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
The summer of lower prices continues at Fleet Farm. Take Sprout Vitamin Feed Supplement for livestock. 25-pound bags, now only $19.99. And for you birders, KT Midwest Regional Blend is just $12.99 for a 7-pound bag. Plus, get 12 mega rolls of Quilted Northern Ultra for only $12.99. And enjoy Fleet Farm Beef Jerky for just $8.79 a pack. Look for new lower prices on everything you need for everyday life with price drops at Fleet Farm.
This is Jen, Gabe, and Chewy.
I'm going to go with the corn dog, the old corn dog. The corn dog for the
pierogies birthday. And borscht all day long.
That's just crazy. Nobody likes borscht, let alone
God,
on their
it's
birthday.
So good. It's the only thing that makes my mouth water, other than my wife.
On 94.5 ESPN.
To Packers Family Night, opportunity for the people in the arena, in the stadium, to see the team. Not so much for the people watching on television. Your reaction, Gabe, to Family Night. I know people were very pleased with the new kicker, Anders Carlson.
Yep, 8 of 9, I believe.
Mm-hmm. What else?
That's about it.
That's it? I thought for sure we'd be able to rattle off a litany of things.
No, I mean, it's just, it's... I don't know. I just don't understand, like, wanting to make these big, broad proclamations off of just a couple of practices. You know? I just don't... Yeah, I mean, Jordan Love, from my understanding, again, because we didn't get to see it all, you know, he starts 1 for 5, but then he looks great at the end. Like, these big, bold proclamations, I don't get wanting to just, like, throw those out there. What are we... This is week 3 of practice coming up here. We're going to have the 3rd week of practice for the Packers. They've got their first preseason game. We'll see if their starters actually play in any of those games. But it's one practice. It was up and down, just like most of the preseason practices have been for Jordan Love.
So let me get this straight. You are saying that you need more to see how good or bad Jordan Love and company are going to be.
Yeah. And I keep trying to tell everyone that. So I was playing in a member guest over the weekend.
I don't know what that means.
I just stopped listening because I knew he was talking golf.
Well, no, so
it's a member guest.
You used to belong to a club.
Uh-huh.
So every year they have their big tournament every year is a member guest, where a member invites a guest to come along, 3 days of golf you're playing, and you're playing like 5 different matches throughout the course of 2 days. So you're getting to meet people. Oh, hey, what do you do? And inevitably, after every time, oh, I work for ESPN Milwaukee, do the morning show. Oh, what do you think of the Packers? What do you think of Jordan Love? Literally don't know. Don't have enough information. The only thing I do know is he's going to struggle at different points. Whether or not he bounces back from that, that's going to tell us a lot. But like, without getting more data points on this guy, outside of just these practices, like I'm hopeful he turns out to be really good, but I have no idea.
So it turns out the GM of the team feels similarly. Take a listen to Brian Gutekunst from Friday.
Oh, yeah, not much. He's done a really nice job. Just like last year, I think defense kind of had the offense early, and that's usually a little bit of the case. But certainly was last year and has been this year. They made some strides over the past few days here, I think. You know, but the next 2 weeks with the opportunities that this football team's going to have between their joint practices, family night, and 2 preseason games, gonna be very big for us.
Let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
If we already talked about competitive advantage and whatnot, and the Packers doing certain things and not showing certain things so that, you know, people get, or don't get, I guess, certain information from the thing, what would stop the Green Bay Packers from skewing Saturday night's scrimmage to benefit the offense? What would stop them? What would stop the defense and the defensive coordinator and the defense from, like, playing easy, playing off a little bit in order to make the offense look good? Because so many of the questions have been about the offense and what this offense can do and how good is Jordan Love going to be, et cetera, et cetera. Like, are you telling me that that type of strategizing is out of the realm of possibility?
Jen, from my understanding of you...
The
time I've gotten to know you doing the show, we're coming up on 3 years, right? Like, are we actually going to remember our anniversary this year?
After the 31st. The show? Okay. So whatever day the 31st is. It's a Thursday. 31st.
We'll figure it out. You're a pretty competitive person.
Yeah.
In a competitive landscape, someone came to you and went, hey... take it easy so the kid can look good. What are you telling the person who just told you to take it easy?
Leap off.
Yes.
Here's the thing. You also know that if I say something on the radio, hear me out.
Yep.
Usually it's because I've heard some things, talked to some people, got some info. Would it surprise you if you heard that the defense was, let's just, you know, it's a big night, 65,000 people plus whoever is sort of watching at home. Let's make the kid look good. Let's make the offense look good. Let's make sure that people walk out of here optimistic, excited about what Jordan Love and company can do. Would that surprise you?
It would.
Really?
It would. Because giving false confidence to your fan base, but then also giving false confidence to your quarterback.
What if he knows about it?
Seems...
He's in on the ruse.
Seems like not a great place to be.
Brian Gutekunst saying that he needs more time, that the team needs more time to determine whether or not how good Jordan is going to be.
We got a month.
Look, we've been critical of things that Brian Gutekunst has said. Are you critical of this, or do you appreciate him being where you are, which is more data points, need the data?
I will always appreciate the honesty, because there are times that I believe he has been less than honest.
You hearing a but here, Ashy? You hearing a, I feel, maybe not
I'm
a but,
for
a however.
No, I appreciate, sure. No, just straight up the honesty here. Because, again, this is more in line of clearly the way he's thinking versus what he was telling us in the, oh, the expectations don't change. Oh, we're the Green Bay Packers. Our expectations don't change around here. But your actions in building this roster have told us differently, Brian. So now this is more in step with what the roster actually looks like. Oh, it's a young team. We got to wait and see how this all comes together. Yeah, I appreciate that honesty from Brian Gutekunst. I will not kill Brian Gutekunst for that comment.
I don't know. I think the way that he said the, it's going to 2 more weeks, we'll know more. Well, okay. That doesn't instill confidence for me, though.
Well, but they have been pointing, and even LaFleur, like they have been in lockstep in this. They have been pointing towards the joint practices as the biggest thing for Jordan Love. Mostly because they've been coy, competitive advantage and whatnot, about whether or not he's going to play in the preseason.
Right.
So they have pointed because they know he's going to practice, and then you get those opportunities against defenses that you're not familiar with and players you're not familiar with. So the joint practice coming up on Wednesday in Cincinnati and then the two next week here in Green Bay against the Patriots, they have always pointed at those being the biggest of the preseason for Jordan Love in terms of his development.
Are you on board with Brian Gutekunst saying that he needs to see more from Jordan Love to know how good he is going to be? 800-990-3776. Apparently, some people have already seen enough from Jordan Love to know that he is not going to be good. Adam Schein, holy moly, did he go hard to the hole on Jordan Love this weekend? We are going to hear from Adam Schein when we return on Jen, Gabe, and Chewy. Have you guys tried Celsius energy drink yet? I told you, I got a nice big box of Celsius at my house. I'm trying to get through the flavors because they sent me all of these new flavors. I did the cucumber lime this weekend. That was very refreshing. I also have a lemon lime that I am waiting to pop open. You had tried the lemon lime.
I tried the lemon lime. Those are solid.
So it takes a lot to get me to move off of my peach vibe. But I think that these new flavors might be just the thing I need. Celsius is, of course, the essential energy that I choose to help stay on top of it all. You can find Celsius at your local retailer. Stay active and energized all day long with Celsius. Celsius Essential Energy Drinks.
Jen, Gabe, and Chewy are back after this on 94.5 ESPN. The place where you make your wildest food fantasies come true.
Mmm!
The place where you take a ride on the iconic giant slide. The place where you smell all the smells? That's right. It all happens at the Wisconsin State Fair. From August 3rd through the 13th, head to State Fair Park for some summer fun. Get your tickets at wistatefair.com.
Are you looking for the perfect restaurant for your next night out? Then make Aria, the acclaimed restaurant inside St. Kate, your next dinner destination. Specializing in artisanal American cuisine, Aria features carefully prepared seasonal entrees along with a robust selection of craft cocktails, wine, and local beer. Join them on Sundays for the restaurant's famous trademark chicken, served family style with sides like mashed potatoes, goat cheese biscuits, and more. Make your plans today to dine at Aria. Learn more and make reservations at aria@stkate.com. That's aria@stkate.com.
Hun, we need to stop putting off getting life insurance.
I know. It's just been so busy, and I'm sure the cost is out of our budget.
Well, Jen told me that they got a $500,000 term life insurance policy from Ethos for less than $23 a month. All online, with no complicated forms and no medical exam. All they had to do was answer a few health questions.
Wait, no medical exam and all online?
I know, right? It's not easy to think about, but if something happened to you, James and I would be...
Okay, I get it. Let's get a quote from Ethos right now. Wow, you were right. There's no medical exam. And Ethos makes the whole online process fast and easy. And look at these rates and coverage options. It's great protection and totally fits our budget.
Ethos. They've removed all the barriers from getting coverage. Go to checkethos.com to get your free online quote. That's checkethos.com. Quote based on a healthy, non-smoking 30-year-old male with a 20-year term policy. Rates may vary.
Injured? Call Gruber Law Offices today. One call, that's all.
Hey, this is Bo stepping in for Ridgetop Larry, here to tell you about Ridgetop Exterior's most affordable payment options, including no interest and low interest financing. For your free estimate, visit RidgetopExteriors.com. Roofing, siding, windows, and doors, visit RidgetopExteriors.com.
Did you know half of all cats in the United States don't see a vet on a regular basis? Hi, I'm Kat Dennings, and I love cats. Like, really, really love them. Seriously. That's why I'm here to ask you to take your cat to the vet each and every year. I'm working with Royal Canin and Orphan Kitten Club in their program Mighty Cat, the first grant program in the world to protect and care for newborn kittens. For the Take Your Cat to the Vet initiative, which encourages cat owners across the country to schedule annual vet visits. Since it's tricky to decode our cat's behavior, it is super important to collaborate with your veterinarian to uncover any potential illnesses and learn the signs that something could be wrong. As pet owners, it is our responsibility to make sure cats of all ages have a chance to live a full and happy life by providing the care they need and deserve. Visit orphankittenclub.org/mightycat to learn more.
This is Jen, Gabe, and Chewy.
363. What's that?
Oh, the number of yards they gave up on the ground against the Philadelphia Eagles.
It's a Bible verse, John 3:63. Look it up. Tell us what it says.
I thought it was Joe 3:63, and it was, thou shalt not get past me on the line of scrimmage.
On 94.5 ESPN.
To the Adam Schein comments about Jordan Love shortly. Also want to talk about college football and the realignment and whether or not all this stuff makes college football better or worse. That coming up in the second hour of Jen, Gabe, and Chewy. But before we get to that, guys, I saw a picture this morning on social media of a woman reaching down into her dishwasher, lifting the utensil carriage out of the dishwasher, closing the bottom drawer and putting the utensil carriage on the door of the dishwasher before closing it and starting it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And?
That's a thing?
It's normal.
It's how you do dishes in a dishwasher, isn't it?
I've never done that. Our carriage sits where her carriage sits initially, and it stays. It's like a good dog.
Not why am I.
Good for your carriages?
I didn't know that you were supposed to take it out of the bottom drawer and put it on the door.
Well, you don't have to. I think it's just an option so you can create more space for
dishes. Oh, if you need more space in the bottom.
That still gets washed.
So a lot of people are reacting to this in the comments, and we can send the video out on our Jen, Gabe, and Chewy Twitter account if you haven't seen it yet. But a lot of people are reacting saying, yeah, that's what the instructions for the dishwasher tell you. If you read the instructions, you would know that you can remove the utensil carriage and put it on the door of the dishwasher, which got me thinking, who's still reading instructions? When you get a toy or you get a thing or you get a gadget, and I'm not even talking about like the Apple agreement that we all clearly scroll agree to. I'm talking about real instructions, directions, whether it's putting something together or whether it's how does this work. How many people out there are still reading the directions, Gabe?
If it's something I'm putting together myself, I will look at it. Like, dishwasher is installed for you, right? I mean, some people will obviously install it themselves. Good for you. But, you know, I would say the majority of people are probably having the dishwasher installed for them by some sort of professional. So I can understand not reading directions in that instance. The last thing I think I may have put together was last year for my wedding, a bunch of the people here, a bunch of my friends here at Good Karma Brands, pitched together and got me a Traeger grill. And there weren't a ton of instructions to that because it was mostly, you know, assembled when it got there. But there were a couple of things that you had to do. And it's an expensive piece of equipment. So I want to make sure I do it right and don't mess anything up and then have to explain to my friends that, hey, this nice gift you got me, by the way, it doesn't work because I'm an idiot and I put it together wrong.
So to me, this is a double-edged sword of pride. It's either you're proud that you can do it without the directions, which I would argue is probably frivolous and silly, or the pride of, I got to present this sucker to somebody at some point, and I want it to work. I want it to function. I want the drawers to all pull out correctly, or I want, you know, the sound that it makes to be the, like, all of the things. So I'm just wondering if this is a generation thing. It feels like the older generation, which I think includes our parents, were big into directions, but also could do all of the things. Like, my dad knew how to drywall. My dad knew how to roof. My dad knew how to do all of those things. Now, did I try to learn some of those things from him? Yes. But also probably because at the start of the process, he read the damn directions.
Yeah.
So is this like, wait, is our there generation is just like, I got this? Or is our generation like, I don't got this, but I got some coin in my pocket and I'm going to hire somebody who can? Like, where are we sitting?
I got to imagine that we are mostly directions, because otherwise this is how this works. YouTube wouldn't be a thing. Like, how many instructional videos exist on YouTube?
That's a great point.
Where someone's like, wait, where are there? Oh, I don't need the instructions. I'll just watch the video on how to do this.
Which is what I
do. Lost the instructions.
Which also, by the way, it just depends on how you learn. Like, I'm a visual learner, so sure. Watching someone do it on YouTube is actually easier for me than reading and comprehending and trying to, like, understand the verbiage and all of that stuff,
well,
right?
Also, because, like, how many times have you looked at the instructions and the picture on the instruction? Wait, what angle do I have to hold
IKEA
this at?
Is the worst about this. Do not get me started. When I moved into my apartment, I was like, oh, I'm going to go to IKEA and get some new things for my apartment. Did I build everything? Yes, I did. Did I follow the directions? Of course I did. I barely could do that. However, IKEA instructions, please.
Any leftover parts?
Yeah, of course. I don't
always
have to do those.
Leftover parts.
So now you're a little nervous that something's going to fall apart.
Yeah, of course.
I think that IKEA just throws in a few extra parts on all of its things just to mess with everybody. Like,
which would be hilarious, but like, there's no words.
Where is this bracket even supposed to go on this thing?
Just put some words.
IKEA employee back there just chuckling at like the chaos he's created in the environment. Are you a directions person? Do you read directions? Or do you just look at something and assume you can figure it out? And this hits close to home for me because yesterday, my daughter got several gifts for her baptism celebration, and one of the toys the girls immediately asked for us to open and so they could play with it. So Dario takes it out. I know he found the directions because they were sitting on the kitchen counter along with the screwdriver that he used to open the back of the toy to put the batteries in. That might have been the extent of the use of the instructions, okay? Because he put it together fine, but he instructed the girls how to use it incorrectly. So then they come to him and they're like, it's not working. And he's like, oh, crap, I didn't know. And again, to his credit, he was good about being like, I messed up. I made a mistake. This is how you're supposed to use it. But in my head, I was going, well, that's not true. It was out loud. Out loud, I said. You have to read the directions, girls.
Wait, so not only was it not in your head, it was just very passive aggressive.
Yes, it was. My girls are 5 and 3. They can't read. Are you a directions person? 800-990-3776. Or do you, like my husband yesterday, just toss them aside and assume how difficult could it be? 800-990-3776. I also think that this might, and I don't know for sure, but there might also be a gender gap on this thing. I think that men, again, going back to I can figure it out, they might be less inclined to read directions than a woman.
Something lower stakes like a toy, I get it. Like, you should be able to figure out how a toy works,
oh,
right?
Okay,
like,
wow.
It's for...
Who's dropping grenades now? Who's throwing grenades now, Gabe?
No, I was just saying, like, I was initially with him, you know, the fact that he didn't figure it out is on him. But, like, yeah, for a toy, you think, again, if it's something big and something expensive that I want to make sure doesn't break, I'm probably looking at the instructions just to be safe.
Josh in Lake Geneva weighing in on our ESPN Milwaukee talk and text line saying, happy to build your IKEA furniture next time, Ashton. I love building things from IKEA. If I were you, I would take Josh in Lake Geneva's number down.
It. I'm just asking
oh,
IKEA.
Of course you can.
I can, yeah, because I follow the directions. However, it takes me probably 4 times as long as the next person. That's all.
Chef Ed weighing in saying, directions are like a receipt. If you're not familiar with something, you should read it. Like a receipt when you go shopping? Like when you go grocery shopping and you're like, what is this thing that ended up in my shopping bag? Let me check the receipt.
Recipe, Jen. It says recipe.
It does say recipe.
Oh, my God.
Now who Chef can't Ed. Read?
Clear.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, that's bad. That was a quick gander.
Receipt?
And
I was about to light
Although,
Chef Ed
receipt
up for
and
dumb.
Recipe
don't
are very
try,
similar.
Don't try to
how do you spell receipt? How do you spell receipt?
R-E-C-E-I-P-T.
And how do you spell recipe?
R-E-C-I-P-E.
That sounds like a lot of the same letters,
but
Ashy.
But they're in different orders, and also receipt has a T in it.
Sounds like a lot of letters. Sounds like a lot of similar letters there. I think I'm off the hook on this one.
No, I think you just got to own this one.
Yeah, directions and receipts?
Like,
of course
like
it's
Dario
sense.
With
yeah.
the directions.
Yes.
I made a mistake.
Yep.
I should have done it differently. I should have read the instructions. Never.
Wow.
Receipt?
Well, and also, just so you guys
receipt
know.
Receipt doesn't even make sense
that's
there.
An egregious error. That's more egregious than the State Fair thing, I think. No, it's not.
No.
Directions can be comparable to a recipe, is what Chef Ed was trying to say, if you're not familiar
he
with
said it.
More
sense.
Read.
He said it. You
that
were trying to
makes,
say it.
That actually makes a lot,
makes
more,
a lot more sense
than what I was saying.
I mean, you were going to try to save it for Chef Ed, like receipt? Okay, I'll save receipt here, and I'll try to spin this some way. And now
anyway,
you're trying to save it for
anyway,
yourself.
Anyway, we can delete this out of the system so there are are no receipts?
No, I've already screen capped this one, so we're good.
Ah, more Jen, Gabe, and Chewy right after this.
Full show podcasts, interviews, and special content is available right now at WisconsinOnDemand.com. This is Jen, Gabe, and Chewy on 94.5 ESPN.
We're seeing some delays in a usual trouble spot. We have 43 southbound Brown Deer Road to downtown coming in at 19 minutes. That's about 8 minutes more than your usual time. But otherwise, travel time's pretty good across the system and no major incidents to report. Traffic is brought to you by Fifth Third Bank. Custom solutions built around your goals. Member FDIC. For your weather today, partly sunny, a spotty shower possible, a high of 79 degrees. Tonight, partly cloudy and a low of 65. On Tuesday, mostly sunny. Pop-up storms possible, a high of 84. On Wednesday, mostly sunny with a slight chance of a shower or storm and a high of 86 degrees. Thursday, mostly sunny and a high of 83. And on Friday, a chance of rain or storms, partly cloudy and a high of 85 degrees. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Steph Graham on 94.5 ESPN.
Got chronic joint pain but want to avoid steroids and surgery? Take some advice from pro football legend Emmett Smith. Call QC Kinetics.
Let QC Kinetics help you improve your quality of life with biologic therapies that get your body to repair and restore damaged tissue.
These exciting new regenerative treatments from local medical professionals can help your body heal itself with lasting pain relief.
Trust me, you want to avoid surgery if you can. Check out these biologic treatments to see what your options are.
QC Kinetics, restorative regenerative solutions with no downtime, no surgery, no drugs.
I'm talking about joint pain we all can relate to in your knees, your shoulders, your hips, and your lower back. They'll get you feeling good again.
Get relief now.
What are you waiting on? Make the call to QC Kinetics. Tell them Emmett Smith sent you.
Call QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
They talk about everything, but sports always comes first.
Yes, they believe he's going to win. Do they believe he's going to win his first year? Hell no. If they thought Jordan Love could win this year, they sure as hell would have Mason Crosby back as a place kicker.
They haven't seen anything. They've been telling you to temper expectations. The problem is they were in a bad situation with Rodgers. They had to do what they had did. You got to kick the tires on Love. It's time.
And Aaron Rodgers didn't win his first year.
Spend your afternoons with Homer and Tony. Weekdays 2 to 4 on 94.5 ESPN.
Hey, this is Tony Smith. You're listening to 94.5 ESPN, WKTI, WKTI HD Milwaukee.
A locally owned Good Karma brand station.
Showtime. The right way to start your day. This is Jen, Gabe, and Chewy.
I'm no alpha.
Well, then you can't hang with us. I'm sorry.
You never invite us
anyway. If sloppiness is the reason why you don't want to eat wings on the bone,
not just
you're not hanging out with me and the Blammer ever.
I don't think it's the kind of thing you want to hear about your father. But I'll tell you, when he came out of that bathroom and he was kneading that dough, it was a wild scene.
How could he not have washed?
Even if you're not going to soap up, at least pretend for my benefit. Turn the water on. Do something.
This is Jen, Gabe, and Chewy.
If you invite us, I will be as sloppy as I need to be to hang out. I immediately regretted saying that. But I can't just.
I think you just got uninvited.
I'm a puppy. I think you better come with me. What's the problem?
What do they want from Poppy?
Well, Poppy's a little sloppy.
This is Jen, Gabe, and Chewy, broadcasting live from the Gruber Law Office's One Call That's All studios at The Avenue with Gabe Neitzel and Mark Chamora. Here's Jen Lattis.
She's running around, she wants to ride, she's trying to hide it. I'm cool as ever, she's too excited. Her man looks
like the sports world is talking about Jordan Love and the Green Bay Packers. This is undeniable. One, Jordan Love is trending on Twitter right now. Now, sometimes that's regionalized, so sure. I am in Wisconsin, so maybe it is more of a Midwestern or a Wisconsin thing, but he is trending. I see they're talking about him on Good Morning Football. We're going to try to effort that sound. They're having conversations about what does success look like in year one for Jordan Love, which I'd be curious, Gabe, what your position on that is, what your answer to that. If I teed you up and said, what does success look like for Jordan Love in year number one, what would you say?
I don't know if that's a statistical thing, Like, Rodgers, you know, was over 4,000 yards, 28 touchdowns his first year as a starter. I don't know if he's going to get there, mostly because the offense is so young. Like, everything else around him is also as young as he is, so it's just going to be tougher for him to kind of reach some of those statistical milestones. So it's going to be the, I want to see improvement, and I want to see him significantly better at the end of the season than he was at the beginning of the season. And that's hard to quantify. It's more the eye test. And I know everybody hates the eye test because it looks different to everyone else, but I think it's got to be the eye test with him based on what the rest of the roster around him looks like. Like, you think about Justin Fields last year for Chicago and how high a lot of people are on the Bears this year because of what he did and where he started the year and where he ended the year, despite them having the worst record and getting the number one overall pick in the draft. But they were excited about Justin Fields because he showed progress throughout the course of the season. So I'm not saying the Packers are going to have the worst record in the league. I don't think that's going to happen, but I also don't think they're going to have a winning record because of how young this team is.
Kyle Brandt on Good Morning Football was saying that, you know, you start out by beating the Bears, that Brett Favre and Aaron Rodgers had this unbelievable record against Chicago. That's your division rival. You go out there and you cannot lay an egg week one, and he thinks that would be a key to success, or at least how you measure success for Jordan Love. There is also an article right now on SportsIllustrated.com, just dropped a few moments ago. The moment the Packers knew Jordan Love was ready to take over for Aaron Rodgers. If you have some time today, I encourage you to take a gander through that, read through that, because everyone is talking about Jordan Love, and that includes Adam Schein. Adam Schein from CBS Sports Network, who does not think that Jordan Love can do it, is not on the Jordan Love bandwagon compared to all of those ESPN personalities that we have been hearing from over the last few weeks. And Adam Schein, guys, goes super hard to the hole. Take a listen.
How about in the NFC? The Green Bay Packers offense going to be fine with Jordan Love. Loathe. I loathe Love. Despise Love. I mean, everyone looks great during preseason practices, except apparently for Jordan Love, who by his own admission has struggled, and you have players on defense calling out the offense. And just take a look at these notes, according to Matt Schneidman, from his piece in The Athletic. I mean, this is a flat-out debacle. It's also predictable, because Jordan Love can't play football. Simple as that. You have Rasul Douglas. He's talking all sorts of smack to Aaron Jones, saying, you guys bleeping stink. Jones is livid, and then acknowledges the offense is terrible. Defensive players are calling out the offense. Jordan Love can't do a damn thing. Last night must have been hell for the fans of the Green Bay Packers, who have to see Aaron Rodgers on the Jets sideline. Oh, by the way, big dog Mercedes Lewis just signed with the Chicago Bears. This is going to be a predictable disaster with Jordan Love in Green Bay.
Debacle? Disaster? This is an outrageous take. There's not enough, as Gabe was saying earlier, data to support either side of this. There's not enough data that Jordan Love is going to be the next Hall of Famer to wear green and gold. There's not enough data to say that he is going to be a disaster. There is data, however, Gabe, that says that Jordan Love does know how to play football. Like, where in the world are we pulling this garbage from?
I don't know.
I'm reading an article right now. It seems like he's making things up.
Like, so he's taking trash talk from practice as, like, there's
evidence?
Yeah. That doesn't make sense.
I'm reading an article right now. The moment that Matt LaFleur knew that Jordan Love could be the next guy. And it says that this, and finally, in this moment, they felt that Love could really play. And he's detailing a moment on the field. I believe it is in the Philadelphia game. I'm just scrolling through it here as we're sitting here, as y'all were listening to Adam Schein. I'd heard Adam Schein. I could go ahead and scroll through this article while he was talking. I don't understand how you can make such an egregious, out there, definitive point about somebody who has, what do we say, 83? Is 83 the number?
83, I believe, is the number.
Of passes in the National Football League game?
Uh-huh. I don't get it. I don't understand where he's getting it from. I was going to say, maybe he didn't even, I mean, even if he watched Family Night and this was Friday, he made these statements Friday before Family Night. It's not like you'd have been able to make any definitive statements after watching Family Night because, well, even if he watched on TV, you weren't getting much information out of that. Has Jordan Love been up and down during this? Yeah. I think Rob Demosky had the quotes last week that were on ESPN about, yeah, there have been times where it's looked like this could be a long season. There have been times where it's looked like, hey, maybe he's the guy. which is kind of expected for a young quarterback, having the ups and downs, and you want to judge the young quarterback, really any young player, what do they look like at their best, because you know that's the potential that they could, you know, maybe live up to. What the hell is Adam Schein doing here? And good for Devondre Campbell for seeing this on Twitter, X, whatever it's called, stepping up and defending his guy. Tweeting how, no, you don't get to say this. Let this guy actually play some games as a starting quarterback before you start coming at him this hard.
Now, Adam Schein has had Aaron Rodgers on his show a few times, and I think that's noteworthy because Aaron Rodgers doesn't just go out and do all of the things. He doesn't do all. Now, does he do them? Certainly he does. We're not sitting here, right? You and I were rattling off a list the other day of all the interviews that Aaron Rodgers has done over the last few years after somebody, and I think it was Peter Schrager from Good Morning Football, was like, Rodgers never talks to anyone. And we were like, well, Mina Kimes.
McAfee.
And Aubrey Marcus. And Joe Rogan. And I do believe he's doing a sit-down
Pete
this
Holmes?
Year with Monday Night Football's Michelle Beisner. Who's Pete Holmes?
He's a comedian. That's when he was talking about UFOs.
Oh.
With like Pete Holmes.
My brain immediately went to Pete Wentz and whoever the Holmes guy is that used to be on MTV. That's where I was sitting for a minute there. Clearly not that guy. So he does do, but is this Schein just trying to cozy up to Rodgers? Like in some sort of like Jets and Sharks type of thing? Like you have to pick a team, you have to be on either side, and he's clearly, without question, on Team Rodgers? Because I feel like that's overly simplistic. We don't need to do that. You can be pro Rodgers, you can want Rodgers to have success in New York, and also want Jordan Love to have success. Because of what he has been through, because of the journey he has been on, because of how well he has handled the last 3 years of relative chaos. So I'm not sure you have to sit here and take sides, Adam Schein.
No, because Rodgers isn't taking sides. Like, Rodgers reached out to Jordan Love before training camp started. It seems like Rodgers is rooting for Jordan Love to be able to go out there and have success. So I don't know where this came from. I don't know. I guess he maybe wanted to stick out and be the first out there. He could end up being right. He could end up being right. And Jordan Love isn't the next guy for the Packers. But he's not right because of 2 weeks of training camp.
Well, you mentioned Campbell responding to the Adam Schein sound on Jordan Love. Let's hear from another defensive player. And I was just talking about how Good Morning Football is discussing Jordan Love this morning. Because everybody's discussing Jordan Love, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's a very, very hot topic in the NFL right now. Probably the biggest unknown other than a rookie quarterback coming in and starting for a franchise a la Anthony Richardson in Indianapolis. So let's hear what Jason McCourty had to say this morning on Good Morning Football about what he needs to see from Jordan Love to deem it a success.
The way I'm going to phrase is I need to see the it factor from him. There's
okay.
a different type of hope when you're sitting on the bench and it's a 2-minute drill and you just got to stop on defense. Offense marches back out there and your quarterback is under center and you're like, all right, we're good. Go win us the game.
Mm-hmm.
The confidence of a defensive player to have that in their quarterback is different mm-hmm. because I played 13 years in the league, and for majority of my career, we didn't have that. We were on defense, and we gave up a score. It was like, well, better luck next week, guys, because the quarterback was getting out there, and you knew at some point, whether it was an interception, a sack fumble, something was going to go wrong on that drive. For Jordan Love this year, we need to see signs of promise. They may be, to your point, a 6-win team, an 11-win team.
I don't know.
That number needs to change because of the quarterback. Jordan Love needs to come in there at a crucial point in the game, whether it's a 2-minute drill, whether the Packers are up 3 points in the fourth quarter, and he puts an amazing drive together mm-hmm. to put them up 2 scores. That's what you need to see to the point where a defensive player, a general manager, somebody within that Packers organization knows when Jordan Love goes trotting onto the field, it's just like, we have a chance.
And you don't know that until you get the opportunity to go out there and do it. There was a lot of buzz and hope around Aaron Rodgers because of what he did in 2.5 quarters in Dallas in 2007 going into 2008. But you didn't know if he was going to be the guy that eventually later in his career would get the ball back on the 25-yard line with 37 seconds left and no timeouts, be able to hit Devontae Adams twice and get you in field goal range to go win that game. It took a while to get there. It took a while for Tom Brady to get there. You got to go be able to go out there and prove it. And Jordan Love is going to have 2 years, basically, to prove it that he can be that guy for the Green Bay Packers. But the defense is going to have no idea how, you know, if they get a stop late in a game and they're down 4 points, they get the stop, Bears punt it back to the Packers. I mean, they probably hope that Jordan Love can get it done. They don't know how he's going to react in that situation in an actual game.
Jordan Love has talked about how he is shutting out all of this stuff, right? And that is part of when you are the guy, that is one of the bigger differences, other than all of the responsibilities, obviously, that fall at your plate and learning all the play calls. And in that article that Monday Morning Quarterback put out, it talks about how Jordan Love had a list when he was the backup of do not call this play if I go in. And Matt LaFleur was seeing the coverage that he liked to call a play that was on Jordan Love's list. And he was like, can we do this? And Love said, yeah, let's let it fly. Like, let's let it eat. And so they went ahead and called a play that he had previously kind of shied away from, maybe from a talent thing, maybe from an experience thing, who can say? But again, all of that is progress. And all of that is a part of why a lot of people are excited about turning the page over to a new guy. But I think him having to shut out all of this stuff, this is a great reminder of that. Mm-hmm. This is a great reminder 100%. Of... you need to not be hearing the noise. You need to not be paying attention to the ESPNs and the Good Morning Footballs and the CBS Sports, because every week people are going to be praising you or criticizing you. And it doesn't really do him any good to be buying into any of it. He's got to just exist in his own space, live his own journey. And it seems like from everything we're hearing, guys, he's got a good head on his shoulder and that he will continue to try to do that.
That's so hard. To literally ignore everything else going on.
Oh, please. Who are you talking to? Honestly. In the break, I'm telling you, I've got this jag bag out there who's sending me tweets and, like, you know, thinks I'm part-time at ESPN and whatnot. Like, yeah, trust me, I hear it. But you just go, I can't. I don't have the time for that. I don't have the bandwidth. And I'm hoping that Jordan Love has comparable reaction to some of this stuff.
And again, it's hard not to see it. Or for someone, for a buddy. A friend. Oh, hey, did you see this?
Well, because Rogers always used to tell us that,
yeah.
Right? That he wouldn't go out and seek the stuff. Okay, I'm sorry. Not sure that that's exactly true, but especially for somebody who always had to have a chip on his shoulder, mm-hmm. appreciated the slights and used them as motivation. But he would say that buddies would tell him. Buddies would send him tweets or send him comments or send him clips. And then it would make its way into his consciousness.
Like, it would have been so much easier to ignore that stuff when Chewy was playing. Because even if a friend saw it, hey, did you read this article in USA Today? No, I did not read the article in USA Today, and you cannot send it to me because I would have to go to the newsstand and actually get a physical copy.
Right, but also, once you say that, you can't unring that bell.
Oh, 100%.
Like, once it's said, did you see what USA Today is saying about you? Can you go, nope, sure didn't, I'm not thinking about it at all for the next 24 hours.
But it's just so much easier to, like, send that information to your friends now. You know, if you've got a buddy who's playing in the NFL and you're consuming everything because you're rooting for your buddy, it's so easy to just, you know, send that tweet, send that article via text messages versus, you know, you had to send carrier pigeon back in 1994.
I guess that is my hope from this Adam Schein comment. And Schein did go on to explain that he thinks, I saw the tweet, man, he thinks that Jordan Love cannot play football at this level and that the Packers ruined a title team. I don't know how they ruined it. I assume he means by drafting Jordan Love in 2020, they ruined a title team.
And that's going to be a narrative. If Jordan Love fails, that will 100% be the narrative. And that's going to be part of Goody's legacy.
What does success for Jordan Love in year one look like for you? That's what the Good Morning Football team is debating this morning. And that's what we're wondering how you are feeling. What does success look like for you? I mentioned it. You know, for some people, it might just be beating the Bears twice. That'd be success. You know, it'd be obvious that he was taking the rivalry seriously or whatever. But whatever it is for you, I'm curious. For Gabe, it's progress. He wants to see progress. It's not so much about the numbers, the stats, the record. It's, is this guy getting better? More command of the offense. More comfortable out there every single week. 800-990-3776.
Jen, Gabe, and Chewy continues next on 94.5 ESPN.
We have an incident to report. If you're traveling in Washington County, US 45 South, just a bit beyond the ramp from Wisconsin 145, the right shoulder is blocked there due to a crash. So that could be causing some delays if you are up in that area. Otherwise, things looking pretty good across the system. Slight delays on 43 southbound, Brown Deer Road to downtown. That's going to take you 16 minutes instead of the usual 11. Traffic is brought to you by Fifth Third Bank. Custom solutions built around your goals. member FDIC. Taking a look at your forecast today, partly sunny, spotty shower possible with a high of 79 degrees. Tonight, partly cloudy and a low of 65. Tomorrow, mostly sunny, pop-up storm possible, a high of 84. On Wednesday, mostly sunny with a slight chance of a shower or storm, a high of 86. Thursday, mostly sunny, high 83. And on Friday, a chance of rain or storms, partly cloudy and a high of 85 degrees. Weather is brought to you by Elkhart Lake, Wisconsin's Road America. The SRO GT World Challenge features exotic sports car racing at Road America August 18th through the 20th. Get your tickets today and check out the full schedule online at roadamerica.com. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Steph Graham on 94.5 ESPN.
The time has come for another Delzer ESPN Milwaukee Open at the Bog in Saukville. We're excited to be out there all day long on August 8th. The 2023 Delzer ESPN Milwaukee Open at the Bog is sponsored by Welke's Milwaukee Florist, Discount Liquor, The Jewelry Center, Von Breezen, Fifth Third Bank, Cider Heating, Gruber Law Offices, Perky's Old Fashioned, Fast Signs, Three Tree Marketing, and Wisconsin Golf Trips.
Guten Tag, Eliana here from Milwaukee Pretzel Company. My mom and dad usually do these commercials, but I'm taking over this month to share an important message for parents. Summer's almost over, and it's time to start thinking about after-school snacks. Milwaukee Pretzel Company's soft pretzels are the perfect after-school snack. A few minutes in the oven, and they are ready to go. Moms and dads love them, too. You can find our pretzels in the freezer section of your local grocery store or order online at MilwaukeePretzel.com. How did I do, Dad?
Oh, great job, kiddo. I could not have done it better myself.
Get it?
Dad.
Hey, y'all. My name is Tiara, and a little thing that I love about the Chick-fil-A spicy chicken biscuit is that it has the perfect amount of spice to jumpstart my day. Whoever thought of it, thank you so much.
Hi, my name is Robert, and a little thing I love about Chick-fil-A spicy chicken biscuit is the biscuit. It reminds me of my grandma's homemade biscuit. It's always buttery and savory. Then you add the spices, instant classic.
Order the spicy chicken biscuit on the Chick-fil-A app today. Real Chick-fil-A guests paid for their testimonials.
So you're in the middle of a kitchen update, and you can't tell if that's a faucet stem or a flange. With the Home Depot app, doing doesn't miss a beat. It'll find what you need in a snap, and it'll show you how to find it in store with a tap. Or get it delivered free. For doing that doesn't stop, download the Home Depot app. It's made for doing.
Diabetes, high blood pressure, anxiety meds, everyone's on them. If you're a 50-year-old male, maybe a bit porky, and you may even have type 2 diabetes, $1 million of term insurance may only cost you about $200 a month. Call Term Provider. Speak with Big Lou at 800-511-3535. Big Lou will find a term life policy for you even if you have type 2 diabetes, are overweight, or have high blood pressure. Term Provider has helped thousands of people like you who think they can't afford term life insurance. To buy $1 million of affordable term life for you, all you need to do is call Big Lou at 800-511-3535. Lou will make sure the scales are tipped in your favor. Call 800-511-3535. Big Lou will answer your call and work to fit you into a term life policy that you can afford. Remember, Big Lou's like you. He's on meds too. Call 800-511-3535, 800-511-3535, or biglou.com.
You're listening to Jen, Gabe, and Chewy.
I mean, this world is geared towards women.
Like, what do we get? I am stepping away from this. Goodbye.
Like, what do we get? They get a comb that dries your hair. We get a stupid razor. Hey, what's the coolest thing we get? They get the hair dryer.
Control.
On 94.5 ESPN.
The moment the Packers knew Jordan Love was ready to take over for Aaron Rodgers. It is in the Monday Morning Quarterback section of Sports Illustrated. Albert Breer is the author. And there is a section in there where Matt LaFleur, and it does feel like if you've been following Jordan Love's journey, there are these checkpoints. There are these moments that people talk about a lot. Matt LaFleur does talk about that game against the Kansas City Chiefs where I think it's Spagnuolo.
Yeah, Steve Spagnuolo
is the defensive coordinator. Blitzed the hell out of Jordan Love. and how, and that's been talked about, right? I think Brian Gutekunst has been on the record saying we didn't put him in the best situation to succeed in that game, and Matt LaFleur is still talking about how he wished he had put him in a better position, changed the circumstances a little bit. So as we talk about what does success for Jordan Love look like, you got to imagine most defensive coordinators are going to be blitzing the hell out of him,
mm-hmm.
right? Like
at least early.
Because you blitz the hell out of him, and if he can handle it, then you pivot. But at least try. At least go zero blitz to start and see if he can. And again, because it's an easy game plan. If he can't handle it, you just keep doing
keep
it.
Keep going after
right?
him. And that's where.
Don't reinvent the wheel.
Young wide receivers also make me nervous. You know, and I know Chewy's talked about maybe they don't do as many checks at the line at you know, just one hot route anymore like they did back when he played at this point in the NFL. But having the receivers be able to adjust because they know that the quarterback's clock is going to be a little bit quicker because of the blitz coming at him, there's a lot that has to go into that. And with this team being as young as it is at its skill positions on the outside, yeah, of course every team's going to blitz them until they show, hey, we can handle this.
So when you talk about what success for Jordan Love looks like, could it be as simple as being able to pick up the blitz, being able to handle the blitz?
That's step one, but it has to be more than that. Like, that's the base level, right? And then what can you build off of that? Being able to handle the blitz is part of being an NFL quarterback. You have to be able to do it if you want to have long-term success. And that's not saying you're not going to, you know, see every blitz coming your way, because you won't. But being able to handle that and show the poise and be able to run the offense, yes, I think that's going to be a big first step for Jordan Love early in this season. Because the Bears, yeah, the Bears are going to be throwing everything they got at Jordan Love in week one. Guarantee it. Can he handle?
800-990-3776. Dave from Aaron weighing in on our ESPN Milwaukee talk and text line. If Love can win at least 7 games this season and then see progress into year 2 of starting. However, I wouldn't mind seeing a playoff, of course. A playoff game, of course. I wonder if he means season 1 or season 2 there. But it does feel like a lot of people are subscribing to your belief that it's all about progress. It's mm-hmm. all about incremental progress. Not linear, probably, because progress is rarely linear, but at least seeing from week 1 to week 4, right? Maybe you make those benchmarks of yep. the quarters of the season. I know we don't have quarters anymore, Chewy, because we have 17 games and the math.
So after the first quarter of the 5th game, start making judgments.
Exactly. Well, now we're at the quarter mark. So I think that that's where a lot of people are subscribing. But if you've got something else out there, if there's something else out there, loyal listeners, that you are looking for from Jordan Love, let us know. We are wondering, what does success look like for him in year one? Here is what the Good Morning Football crew, Kyle Brandt to be specific, says about what he thinks success for Jordan Love looks like.
Week one at Soldier Field. Yeah. You go in there and you do what Packer quarterbacks do. You go and you own that stadium and you win and you destroy that stadium. They've been doing that since I've been in 7th grade. Aaron Rodgers and Brett Favre are 24-6 at wow. Soldier Field. At Soldier Field. That includes a win in the NFC title game. That includes all 3 times that Jordan Love has watched from the Soldier Field bench. When Brett Favre was inducted in the Hall of Fame, the first clip they showed of him was throwing a touchdown at Soldier Field. When Rodgers goes in the Hall of Fame, the first clip they will show is throwing a touchdown at Soldier Field. You own that place. You own that place for 3 decades. You cannot start game 1, quarter 1, drive 1 of the Jordan Love era and lose in the Chicago Bears' own house of horrors, which is their own stadium, against the Packers. This is the brand for the Packers. It is unfortunately the brand for the Bears. You lose at home to the Packers, to those 2 guys, to those 2 absolute maniacs. Don't show up and lose week 1 and throw 2 picks, and the Bears have turned the page and there's a new generation and Justin Fields looks better than you and he's going to put it, keep it going.
You know I respect the hell out of Kyle Brandt. I think he's fantastic. I think he's incredibly talented. I think he misses the mark here. Because to your point, Gabe, so let's say you're able to handle the blitz. Let's mm-hmm. say you're able to pick up the blitz. But then you go out there the next week and you struggle against the blitz. Winning week 1 against the Bears would be nice. It'd
be great.
It'd be a fantastic start. But if they can't keep up that kind of momentum, if they can't at least continue to put wins together, it'll feel really empty, won't it? Like, it'll
yes.
be the year that my family in Illinois was celebrating with champagne when the Bears beat the Packers on Thanksgiving, right? Am I remembering that correctly? Maybe it wasn't Thanksgiving. Maybe it was later in the year. But my dad popped a bottle of champagne because the Bears beat the Packers in a regular season game. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's what it would be like. People in Illinois would be popping champagne because the Bears, because the Bears beat the Packers, which, again, I don't know if that means anything in the grand scheme of Jordan Love's success for year one.
No. And Aaron Rodgers went out and beat the Vikings week one. Granted, it was at home in his first year as the starter. Then they won week two and then had three losses in a row. It's just going to be up and down. You're going to have these hills and valleys. And yes, eventually, I would love it if Jordan Love continued to dominate the Bears the way that Brett Favre and Aaron Rodgers did. That doesn't mean that domination has to start in week one of year one. Like, if they split against the Bears, they lose at Chicago, but then at the end of the year in week 18, when they play the Bears at home, Jordan Love goes out there and whoops up on the Bears and shows all the progress that he's made. That's more important to me than going into Soldier Field week one and winning the game.
We were also asking people earlier this morning if they gleaned anything from family night, if you were able to. And again, maybe the perception is different if you were in the arena, if you were in the stadium. You think anybody in the stadium gleaned anything about Jordan Love in this offense? Or do you think it was more of you're wrapped up in the excitement, there's pomp, there's circumstance, you're in Lambeau Field, they're going to do the fireworks, you know, people are excited about football being right around the corner. I just don't know if they were able to take anything from Jordan and the offense from being there either.
I doubt it. And the reason why I say I doubt it is because if you just went to the one Saturday practice a week ago where Jordan Love, by all accounts, had his greatest practice ever, and that's the one practice you saw, you're probably sitting there going, oh, the Packers are fine. Jordan Love, he's going to be great. But maybe you went to one of those practices where he struggled and completed 50% of his passes or threw an interception or looked a little frazzled or a little rushed. And you walk away from that going, oh, no. Maybe they made a mistake by trading away Aaron Rodgers. There's the ebbs and flows of it. Maybe you took a couple of things away and went, oh, there's a throw I didn't think he could make, but now I know he can. That's about it. I don't think there are just big sweeping takeaways that you'd have been able to take away from family.
Which is part of the reason why Jason has at times talked about how he wishes that there were more opportunities for the media to see practice, see all of the practices. Because again, if you are just cherry picking practices and even segments of practice, mm-hmm. then it can be really easy to create a narrative one way or another.
Yeah, if you showed up late to family night, you probably think Jordan Love did great because he played great later in practice. If you left early to beat the traffic and all you saw was the early portion of practice where he was 1-for-5 or whatever, you probably walked away not feeling great.
Nobody leaves before the fireworks, Gabe. Everybody stays for the fireworks. The fireworks are the thing.
Are you unfamiliar with how Midwest dads work?
That's true. We got to beat the traffic. Paul Mills weighing in on our Jen, Gabe, and Chewy Twitter account when we were asking you about family night and if you got anything out of it or if it was just more of like, hey, 65,000 people getting together to celebrate the green and gold. Paul was watching on television. He says it seems to have morphed into a pure propaganda portal for the organization. The broadcast was a sham. Wouldn't know since the live stream was killed. Instead of showing the action on the field, we got interviews with the organization and endless commercials. Man, that is true. The commercials. There were a lot of commercials on the television broadcast as well. And it did feel like, I did see somebody comment, that it felt like a Manning cast. Because you had Wayne and Larry kind of in their boxes on the left side of the screen, so also chewing up so you could see more of the stuff. They really were paranoid. They really were not going to show a lot of the actual schematics and game and plays and drives on the broadcast. Just a weird decision by the green and gold.
I'm just hung up on pure propaganda portal. I like that phrase.
It's a band name, isn't it? That's kind of a band name.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. 100%.
Pure propaganda portal.
Yeah. Triple P.
Propaganda portal. PPP.
Yeah.
Like OPP. Hey, what does OPP stand for?
You know what it stands for.
I don't.
But can't tell you when you're older.
Yeah.
You can't say it on the radio?
No.
Nope.
I heard it the other day and I was like, wait, what does this stand for?
Other people's
property.
Yeah, sure.
Yep.
Isn't that what it is?
Yep. Let's go with property.
Is it penis?
Nope.
Okay. I'm trying to think of things you can't say on the radio.
Time to break. Weird. Strange.
We cannot throw to break
other
fast
people's
enough.
Potato.
Oh, that does not. Now I'm feeling uncomfortable about having shouted that.
We warned you.
In the car when I was a child in front of my parents.
In fairness, they probably had no idea
that
what it stood
tracks,
for either.
Doesn't it? All right, we got to take a break. We roll on right after this.
More Jen, Gabe, and Chewy coming up on 94.5 ESPN.
Crews are dealing with a crash on U.S. 45 South in Washington County beyond the ramp from Wisconsin 145. The right shoulder is blocked due to a crash, so be aware of that if you are around the Richfield area. Otherwise, we do have some slowdowns still on 43 southbound. Brown Deer Road to downtown will take you about 16 minutes. That's a five-minute delay. Traffic is brought to you by the Neal Group. They know how to minimize your taxes to keep more money in your pocket. Visit nealgroup.net. That's N-E-A-L group.net. Looking at your weather today, partly sunny, spotty shower possible, a high of 79. Tonight, partly cloudy and a low of 65. Tuesday, mostly sunny, pop-up storms possible, a high of 84. Wednesday, mostly sunny, a slight chance of a shower or a storm and 86 degrees. Thursday, mostly sunny, high 83. And on Friday, a chance of rain, storms, and partly cloudy at 85 degrees. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Steph Graham on 94.5 ESPN.
This is the year to buy the woman you love a big anniversary diamond.
What's a big anniversary diamond?
A big anniversary diamond is any diamond that's at least twice as big as the one in her engagement ring.
Why twice as big?
A big anniversary diamond says, I love you twice as much today as the day I married you.
People are always so happy when they see the price we can give them.
Kessler's has wonderful prices on 1 carat, carat and a half, 2 carat, and 3 carat big anniversary diamonds.
People will ask you about your big diamond everywhere you go. So big anniversary diamonds are the hot new trend? It began with men buying big anniversary diamonds for the women they love, but now it's gone to a whole new level.
Women are now buying big anniversary diamonds for their men.
Women are saying, two can play that game. I like games that two can play. Everybody likes games that two can play. Welcome to Kessler's.
For the location nearest you, go to kesslersdiamonds.com.
Texting enrolls you in reoccurring automated text messages. Consent not required to purchase. Message and data rates may apply.
Hey, Dan, how you doing? Haven't seen you around the gym for a while.
Yeah, I've really fallen off. Since I turned 40, I just don't get the results I used to get.
Could be lower testosterone.
Lower T.
Yeah, I went through it a while back. Once you hit 40, your body has less free testosterone. I got Nugenix Total T, and it's made a huge difference for me.
I've seen that ad on TV. Is it for real?
Oh, yeah. The patented key ingredient is something called Testofen, which helps boost free and total testosterone levels to help you trim up and stay lean.
And it's made a difference for you?
Man, I feel like I'm in my 20s again. At work, in the gym, and in the bedroom.
Are they still giving out complimentary bottles for people to try it for themselves?
Yeah, you just need to send them a text.
Text HUNK to 42424 right now for your complimentary bottle of Nugenix Total T, the number one selling testosterone booster at GNC. Plus, text now and we'll include a bottle of Nugenix Thermo, our most powerful fat incinerator ever, to help you get back into shape fast, absolutely free. Text HUNK to 42424. That's HUNK to 42424.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control of your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank accounts, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problem now by calling the experts at U.S. Tax Shield and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. U.S. Tax Shield offers a price protection guaranteed quote to get you protected today. U.S. Tax Shield is A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau, so call now. 800-687-5192. That's 800-687-5192. U.S. Tax Shield. 800-687-5192.
It's Jen, Gabe, and Chewy.
My father would always say, and there's a rhyme and a reason to it, he said, if you wear your rubbers in the house, you'll go blind. Do the two youngsters on the show here even know what rubbers are? I'm talking the ones that go over the shoes.
On 94.5 ESPN.
What is it about fights in sports that we all collectively love, yet don't really, like, recognize that we love it until they happen, and then we just have this coming together moment on social media? You know, like a fight in football happens, which is rare because they're all wearing helmets, or basketball. I mean, it's mostly, we're talking mostly hockey, because baseball fights are typically, historically, not even fights.
Scrums, we call them?
And that's not even a scrum, because usually,
get-togethers.
Like, just, yeah, like, people start yelling. Then they open up the gates to the bullpen. The bullpens come running out. And everyone's just yelling. There might be some pushing, you know. I mean, now there have been some actual highlights in baseball fights. Who was the reliever for the Reds who just, like, spiked his glove and was ready to take on the entire Pirates team? Big lefty.
I'll remember it, I'm sure, randomly at some point in time. Not Kyle Farnsworth, who just decided to bulldoze the catcher for, I think, the Cubs, maybe?
Yeah, like, that 15, kicked 20 off years one, ago. Yeah. There are some highlights, but they're very few and far between. Like I said, and now I'm not even blanking on the pitcher who's just ready to throw hands with everybody. But we got a legitimate baseball fight over the weekend, and it was trending. People were talking about it. And it came at the cost of you, Ashton, because you're a White Sox fan.
Unfortunately.
And everybody now has more Tim Anderson jokes, which I feel bad for, because Tim Anderson, as little as 2 years ago, was one of the young, exciting players in baseball, and now he stinks.
Amir Garrett. Thank you, Josh.
Amir Garrett, Amir Garrett. He was just ready to literally fight the world. Yes, Amir Garrett. But we got a big fight in baseball over the weekend as Jose Ramirez of the Cleveland Guardians dove into second base. Started talking with Tim Anderson, and here's how the fight sounded on the Guardians Radio Network with Wisconsin native Tom Hamilton.
Here it comes. A swing and a smash to first by the diving Vaughn. Down the right field line. Kicks into the corner. Ramirez on his way to second. Head first slide. Safe and in to score is Jimenez. And another hustle double. Right over the bag at first. Now Hosey and Anderson square off. They're fighting. They're swinging. Down goes Anderson. Down goes Anderson.
I hate my life, man.
And Kevin Harlan has been really just revered in the space of being able to transition from the seriousness of doing play-by-play into then play-by-play of whatever's happening outside of the sports. Like, Kevin Harlan's had a couple of really good ones with streakers and people who end up on the field and his calls on Westwood One with Monday Night Football that he does. But tip of the cap to Tom Hamilton there. To go from play-by-play of baseball to suddenly having to call a boxing match. Because literally, I mean, this is, unlike very few baseball, again, I put it in air quotes, fights I've ever seen. They actually squared up to each other, as Tom Hamilton said.
I mean, if you haven't seen the video, when Gabe is saying that they actually squared up, they both threw their gloves down, put their fists up, and the ump got out of the way like a boxing referee.
And it's, I mean, he had his hand there, and then he pulled his hand away.
Like, you know,
the only thing
I'm
that
good.
Was missing was just him, like, throwing his, you know, like, his fingers apart and then kind of bringing them together, going, go ahead and fight. Because he knew what was about to happen, and he wisely got out of Dodge because Tim Anderson got knocked on his ass.
I want to hear this again.
Now Hosey and Anderson square.
So funny. And I had over a dozen people, I'm not exaggerating, text me when this happened and then, or post the game when the video came out being like, oh no. I knew right away.
Do you think our fans would be honest enough to answer the question, if you found yourself in this situation, who are you likely? Are you the guy? Are you Tim Anderson, who's just wildly throwing punches and not connecting? Or are you Jose Ramirez staying calm, cool, collected, and finding that little opening to pop someone in the jaw and knock them on their ass?
Everything about this.
Because everybody probably thinks they're Jose Ramirez.
But we're all Tim Anderson.
But 75% of us are Tim Anderson.
Up that. We're 90%. There's no. It's 9 out of 10. There's one person in every 10 people.
9 out of 10?
There's no chance. Think of a fight. Any fight. If you start the fight, you better finish it. How often are you finishing a fight that you start, though?
No. And the ones you always have to be careful of anytime you find yourself in this situation are kind of the quieter ones.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I've got a buddy who's a former hockey player, and I play golf with him, and he's one of the nicest people ever. And he is fiercely loyal. Like, he will defend his buddies. I'm guessing it would take a bit for him to get that agitated where he gets in a fight. But if he does, like, he's in that 10%. Like, he's going to finish it. Whereas most of the people out there are probably just chirpers and talkers and think that they are Jose Ramirez. But you think it's 90% are Tim Anderson?
I think so. I think there's a lot. Anyone that's willing to fight, I just don't think they're always winning the fight. I don't feel comfortable giving 75%. What do I do? What am I supposed to do with this? It's hilarious to me.
Yes.
And I'm so sad. I'm just so sad.
Well, I mean, I saw all the jokes. Like, you
they
know,
were all
okay,
funny.
Tim Anderson.
Every one of them was
can't
great.
Can't hit anything.
There was a great video where someone laced the Sonic the Hedgehog. As soon as he got hit, the coins came popping out. Hilarious. Every one of them I laughed at. Every single one. With tears in my eyes.
Well, sometimes when your team's a joke, it's just easier to laugh along.
I'm spending money still. I'm going to go see them in Chicago on Friday when they take on the Brewers. And I'm going again in 2 weeks. Why? Why am I doing this? I don't know. Someone stop me.
Fans do weird things. Fans do funny things.
Someone stop me. That's, I guess, what I'm asking.
800-990-3776. Are you Jose Ramirez or are you Tim Anderson? Can we pull that to see how many people would lie?
What are you?
Oh, I'm Tim Anderson. Like, I would just wildly take punches.
I'm the umpire.
I've never actually been in a fight. I've had to try to break up a couple. Like, there have been a couple of times playing men's baseball, not in college or high school, but men's league baseball. Rock River League would have been me, up in Horicon. Home Talent is around Madison. I think Land O'Lakes is down this way, where a couple of guys start shoving, so then, you know, you got to run in from the outfield. You know, you're rarely in on the action. There was one time where I was at the plate, and one of our guys stole third and kind of got pushed over by a guy, so then our benches cleared quickly. No punches were thrown. But most of the on-field baseball have been typical baseball. All right, we're all gonna run here and then just kind of stand around as this thing resolves itself.
I'm going through pictures so I can post something on our Twitter at JenGabeChewy. Every picture is funnier than the last one. These aren't even doctored pictures or memes. These are legitimate just pictures of them squaring up. It's the funniest thing to ever happen in baseball. Not like the best. This is the funniest thing to happen.
Tim Anderson has the same number of KOs as home runs.
That's true and hurtful.
That's for Matthew and Waukesha. Great point by him. But again, I feel like most people are Tim Anderson, even though we all want to believe we're Jose Ramirez. Like, I've never actually had to be in a fight. Again, try to break up a couple. But there aren't very many people out there that's never been in a fight is a very lily white Midwestern thing. Yeah, like, again, all these tough people, like, if you're using the term lily white, Texan in Racine, I don't know. I think you're the fake tough guy. You probably think that you're Jose Ramirez when you're probably Tim Anderson. I think most of us are Tim Anderson. That we all talk a really good game, but when push comes to shove, we're wildly punching while Jose Ramirez hits us in the jaw.
If you're Tim Anderson, you have to bow out for the rest of the season, right?
Yes.
Yeah,
you just got to come back and you got to own it. You got to own it for the rest of the season, because if you disappear now, baseball fans don't forget.
Who's the Brewer that would be Tim Anderson here? That's what I've been trying to think of. There's no one dumb enough to do this on the Brewers.
No, I don't think so.
Who would be Jose Ramirez though?
On the Brewers?
Yeah, who's like, okay, you want to fight? Let's fight.
That's a great question.
I want to say, because of size, I want to say Rowdy, but I think it's Willie.
Yeah, because Willie's like the happy-go-lucky guy.
Yeah.
But I think if you got Willie ticked off enough that he's going to, yeah. And Willie's like surprisingly stout. Like there's more size there than you think. Yeah, I don't think it's, at this point, I don't think it's a lot of the young guys. It might be Willie. Where he ends up being the Jose of this situation.
So anyways, I'm sad.
Yeah. But also, you got to laugh about it over the weekend.
Isn't that what life's about? Being sad and laughing.
We're going to see all the weird things we put on polls coming up next on Jen, Gabe, and Chewy. But with a local Milwaukee team, Fifth Third Bank knows what success looks like. They've been serving businesses and individuals in the area for nearly 15 years, including a longstanding commitment to the healthcare industry. From expansion to technology to reducing the risk of fraud, Fifth Third offers a full suite of financial services and solutions across the healthcare spectrum to meet the complex moments you are navigating. Fifth Third Bank National Association, custom solutions built around your goals. Member FDIC.
Jen, Gabe, and Chewy are back after this on 94.5 ESPN. The place where you make your wildest food fantasies come true. The place where you take a ride on the iconic giant slide. The place where you smell all the smells? That's right. It all happens at the Wisconsin State Fair. From August 3rd through the 13th, head to State Fair Park for some summer fun. Get your tickets at wistatefair.com.
Get in zone, AutoZone.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today? Thinking about gas mileage. You know, changing your oil with a full synthetic oil like Pennzoil Platinum can help your engine get more miles. Right now, you can get 5 quarts with an STP Extended Life Oil Filter for only $35.99. Get started on your next job today with the parts you need when you need them at AutoZone or AutoZone.com.
Get in the zone, AutoZone.
Restrictions apply.
Hey y'all, my name is Tiara, and a little thing that I love about the Chick-fil-A spicy chicken biscuit is that it has the perfect amount of spice to jumpstart my day. Whoever thought of it, thank you so much.
Hi, my name is Robert, and a little thing I love about Chick-fil-A spicy chicken biscuit is the biscuit. It reminds me of my grandma's homemade biscuit. It's always buttery and savory. Then you add the spices, instant classic.
Order the spicy chicken biscuit on the Chick-fil-A app today. Real Chick-fil-A guests paid for their testimonials.
Gruber Law Offices and other business owners help local startups get on their feet on Project Pitch It. Watch it Saturday nights at 10:35 on WISN 12. One call, that's all.
Brian, why are you stacking books on the floor?
I want to stand while I work. Standing desks are all the rage these days.
Well, it's a good thing that these desks move up and down. You did know that, right?
What? They do?
Yeah, we're not messing around here.
This is great. Now, only if I had a chair to swivel around in.
Do you just not pay attention to everybody else's desks?
Well, no wonder I'm not getting much done these days.
Coakley Brothers and Brothers Interiors, the official moving and furniture provider of GKB Milwaukee.
ESPN Milwaukee's Gabe Neitzel here to remind you to attend a DocHounds regular season game this month. Now is the time to attend an exciting, family-friendly baseball experience in Lake Country. The Lake Country DocHounds play at Wisconsin Brewing Company Park in Oconomowoc, right off the interstate. Tickets start at just $10 with home games featuring Bat Dogs, Colton Covu, in-game promotions, a kids area, and more. Go to DocHounds.com for tickets and game times. Catch DocHounds baseball in Lake Country, where summer nights last longer.
Hey, this is Bo stepping in for Ridgetop Larry, here to tell you about Ridgetop Exterior's most affordable payment options, including no interest and low interest financing. For your free estimate, visit RidgetopExteriors.com. Roofing, siding, windows, and doors, visit RidgetopExteriors.com.
Evans Transportation is stoked for the Milwaukee baseball playoff push. After all, they're the complete player when it comes to logistics. But instead of being a five-tool player, Evans is the ultimate three-tool logistics partner. When manufacturers have accounting, shipping, and tracking needs, they come to Evans. And for the record, Evans is happy to leave the stuff to the real players. They'll stick to logistics. Good luck to Milwaukee from Evans and Delafield. Find them at evanstrans.com.
Here in Wisconsin, one name is synonymous with fantastic frozen pizza, Palermo's. For almost 60 years, Palermo's has focused on feeding Wisconsin families. And though Palermo's has grown a lot since 1964, they're still family-owned. They're still proud to call Milwaukee home. And they're still committed to making the best frozen pizza possible. From their new and improved rising crust pizzas to their guilt-free Primo Thin Pies, Palermo's has a delicious slice for every appetite. Find Palermo's in your local grocer's freezer food aisle. Palermo's. Flavor is our family's business.
It's Jen, Gabe, and Chewy.
Was it a mistake?
Yep.
Ashy-bashy.
Yep.
Yes, it was.
Yes. Yep.
You didn't even know what the hell I said.
You asked if it was a mistake.
What was a mistake?
Go back to soccer.
On 94.5 ESPN.
Here we go.
We started the show today by talking about the state fair and all the things that can happen. Still plenty of time to go out to the state fair. Ashy and Jen went to the state fair over the weekend. And Ashy, you said that somebody you were with had to get a corn dog.
Had to get a corn dog, yeah. Just had to. That's why I wanted to go. Had to get a corn dog.
Is getting a fresh corn dog, quote, literally 1,000 times better, end quote, than one that comes out of the freezer section at the store? Ashton, you pushed back on me when I said this.
I stand by that.
81% of people say yes.
I mean, I'll take the L. I stand by that, though. It's the same thing I said to my friend. I said, we can just go to Sam's Club right now and just buy a box of the State Fair branded corn dogs, and you can cook them in the microwave. They'll be just as fine.
No, especially out of the microwave. Like, if you make a corn dog like that, it's got to be in the oven.
No, if I'm making corn dogs, I'm just going to eat corn dogs. It's nothing special. It's a freaking corn dog.
If you put it in the microwave, the breading and everything on the outside becomes soggy, and it's not crisp. You don't get that nice crisp factor the way you do when you're at a fair.
Okay, I will concede. They are better, but I'm not going to say 1,000 times better.
Yeah. It's not even close.
Five times.
They're completely different foods.
They're not.
Yeah, completely different
foods. You're exaggerating. It's not. No, they're not. It's a corn dog, man.
One is soggy. The other is crisp.
They're both corn dogs. What's the actual difference? Maybe 5% difference in taste and flavor?
I said, I stand, it's 1,000 times better. The crispness, you know this. You are somebody who makes food. Texture matters when it comes to food.
I agree.
I don't want just a lot of put dog. Mush in my mouth.
Okay, well, sure. Podcast title.
I want something that's going to have a little more crispness to it. Yeah. That texture makes a difference, Ashton.
I'll concede the loss, but my conditions are that I disagree.
Which is more egregious? Me never going to the state fair or Jen spending $9,000, which apparently was rounded down. So it was over $9,000.
Yes, 100%.
Right?
Yeah.
I don't know if we'll ever get the real total, but she spent $9,000 at the state fair. 84% of people saying Jen, which I think is the right answer.
It is, but come on. 9,000.
And a lot of people, look, I've never been to the state fair, and if we're being honest with each other, I don't know if I'm ever going to go to the state fair. It's almost kind of become one of those things with me, like Titanic, although I did say I would watch Titanic when we were talking with Sophia earlier this season, or Game of Thrones. Like, I'm more dug in on Game of Thrones because everyone told me I had to. Nobody has really said, oh, you have to go to the state fair. You'll really enjoy it. It's just one of those things that has never happened. And I don't feel like I'm missing out on that much.
You're not. As I said earlier in the show, I was there for like an hour and a half. It was fine. I didn't need to go. I went there because my friends were going and we had something to do that night. I walked around a little bit and got bored. Just not my scene.
It's a bigger, I've been to the Dodge County Fair when I was growing up, back when I was in Horicon. Like, I've been to the Dodge County Fair. I'm sure it's just bigger, you know, it's just the Dodge County Fair on steroids. Got a little, you know, bunch of fried food. It's a good time, but yeah, I just haven't gotten around to it. Maybe we will at some point. At this point, would Packers family night scrimmage, or excuse me, would Packers family night, I'm just so used to putting scrimmage at the end of that, even though it's not a scrimmage anymore. At this point, would Packers family night best be served solely as a skills competition rather than a practice or scrimmage? This thing is as tight as it can be. 50.8% say no, 49.2% say yes. And I think there are, I saw some of the videos of the fans they pulled out trying to catch a punt, and the one that Rich Bisaccia coached up, and then he caught the next punt. Like, those things are fun, and they're entertaining, but I doubt that they ever go to it just being a skills competition, basically because this still counts as one of the practices the Packers can have.
Which is, again, another egregious thing. All I'm seeing out of that poll with people basically going 50-50 is that nobody really cares one way or the other about it.
No, they enjoy going to Lambeau Field. They enjoy that whatever the football is put in front of them can still be entertaining for you and your family. And I hope family night never goes away, even if it's just a practice, even if the TV product sucks as you're sitting at home trying to glean more information about your favorite team. I hope family nights and the spirit of it never goes away. And I feel if it went to a skills competition, to be a little bit different. I don't know if you get 65,000, but maybe you do. On Good Morning Football today, Kyle Brandt said beating the Bears in Chicago Week 1 would be a clear sign of a successful season for Jordan Love. Do you agree? 56.8% of people saying yes, 43.2% saying no. Look, I think we kind of landed on, yeah, beating the Bears would be great, but it's not indicative of much. It's about being able to steal a Mike McCarthy phrase, stack those successes. Just as putting everything on Week 1, so if he goes in there, that's a clear sign of failure for the first season? No, it's 1 week. It's just going to be a different season trying to grow and learn with this team than we've typically seen. And I'd like to say most people just have way too much faith in themselves.
Way too much.
Would you be more Tim Anderson, starting the fight with confidence, or Jose Ramirez, landing the knockout blow? 70% of people saying Jose Ramirez.
That's wrong. It's just wrong. I appreciate that people feel that good about themselves and have this confidence in their ability to fight, but it's wrong. It's not true. We're all Tim Anderson in life.
Most fights, even ones that get posted on social media, like, are just so bad. It's just people wildly throwing punches, like Tim Anderson. That's all it is. And Jose Ramirez is the one who closed it. Landed the knockout blow. Knocked Tim Anderson on his ass. Again, I know most people like to think that's who they are. I got a newsflash for you. That ain't true.
They're swinging! Down goes Anderson! Down goes Anderson! They're swinging!
Shout out to Tom Hamilton, Gardens Radio Network, for that call. That's fantastic. We'll be back at full strength tomorrow. Chewy will be back. Looking forward to that. Big guys just skipping Mondays. Wildy and Tausch, coming up next.
The usual trouble spot, 43 southbound Brown Deer Road to downtown, is still pretty heavy at this time coming in.